national exhibition, the Agrodome. As we go inside now, and it's time to read the ice, that's all brought to you by Canadian Airlines. Hans Hutrick is the ice maker, but Ray, you know something? He could be a race car driver.
Hey, Victor, you want it fast? You got it fast. This is fast ice, believe me. From this hog line to this tee line, we're talking 25+. Boy, does it slide. Going around the center guards, lots of movement, about 3 to 3.5 feet. Comes all the way with a great finish. Going around those corner guards, you don't see a lot of it, but when you want to, you're talking 4, 4.5 feet. Starts to move quickly about the center of the ice and then really finishes nicely. When you're hitting from the outside in with that normal control weight, you're talking 2.5 to 3 inches of ice. It'll hold all the way, then break a little bit at the finish. When you're hitting from the inside out, about 8 to 9 to 10 inches of ice, moving nicely. It's very fast in this area, and by that I mean it's very slick. In other words, very hard to judge the sweeping when it moves into this area. You're talking 25+, boy, I tell you, that's tough on front ends. There's no frost buildup at this point, but we'll watch it closely as the building fills up and the temperature gets a little warmer. Two great teams, two world champions. This should be a great one.
Well, in fact, the games throughout the week should be great. It's a very competitive field. On sheet A, our featured sheet, Canada against Saskatchewan, Newfoundland against BC, Laura Phillips from the hometown girl, Kelley Owen from Richmond, Rebecca Jean McPhee is the PEI championship champion from Prince Edward Island, Alberta. Hey, Snow White is back, Kathy Borston. Heidi Hanlon from New Brunswick goes against Chantel Osborne from Buckingham. Those are the games in the opening draw. Those are the byes here in Vancouver. And our sheet, four sheets in this Agrodome, and our featured sheet is on our immediate left as we look across the Agrodome and the two teams, Saskatchewan and Team Canada.
Well, Ray, we have a lot of information on the ice so far. We've been talking to the ice makers, and I think Team Canada is going to have a bit of an advantage this week if it stays fast and stays swingy, because that really favors Marilyn and her style of play.
Well, we talked about handicapping, Linda. You know, it really is difficult to handicap a field like this because there's so much quality out here, and the level of the play is so tremendous. But I agree. I think that there's no question that some ice surfaces, some styles of ice will favor some teams. And Marilyn is one team that really likes to get to go behind things and get going. I think you make a terrific point, Lou, when you talk about the fact it's a big team for game for Team Canada psychologically. You know, it really is hard to prepare yourself for this event when you don't have to go through it all season long. Sandra Schmirler, on the other hand, as I mentioned in my opening comments, had to fight her way through a very tough province, Saskatchewan, as we know, to get back here. And she wanted back badly, and she's here. And that's a strong team. We know they're two-time world champions, both of them are, but this should be just a tremendous curling game.
Team Canada will be throwing red stones, Saskatchewan yellow. And they had a draw to the button to determine rock and hammer in this first game only. The rest of the games will be predetermined. And Saskatchewan has won the draw, so they will have last rock advantage. So to get us going, the Team Canada lead is Jane Hooper-Perot.
We'll see early, I think, Linda, see what they're going to do.
Puppy.
Will they stay a little tentative for a few ends, Puppy, or will they go after each other? It'll be interesting to see. And Marilyn, I think, called the stone into the rings, not short, so this could be a little bit of a defensive end, and that's
on,
kind of common this early in an event.
It's very common. Teams are trying to get the feel for the ice and trying to gain the confidence, as I mentioned. And although they've had practice, they're still jitters going into this. They've stood around with the opening ceremonies and really gotten excited. Now they're just trying to calm down and get ready for the week.
Marcia Gooderite.
Two solid front ends, Vic. Really, they are. You know, Joe McCusker and Marcy are just as good as there's been. And you get a matchup like
really
this.
Swishy.
Jane Hooper-Perot and Corey Beveridge. I really believe when you get such strong teams like this, any separation will be, it will depend on how well the front ends play against each other.
Come on now.
Been quite the curling season for the Perot family.
Jane,
of course, back as defending champion, and her husband Pat will be part of Ed Wernick's team at the Labatt Briar coming up in a couple of weeks in Calgary.
Now, one thing, of course, is Marcy is rejoining the team, and Vic, maybe you should explain this part. She's been away a little bit.
Well, in fact, yeah, the three of the thanks
Mine's
give
good,
the baby questions to me. The
tight.
In fact, they've been mixing and matching this team, haven't they, for about a year now, because Jan Betker, Joan McCusker, Marcia yeah.
okay,
have all
good.
Had babies in the last year. In fact, when we saw Sandra at the JVC TSN women's skins game in Thunder Bay, it was Kathy Trowell playing lead.
That's right.
So that's the one factor. We're not sure of how Marcia will feel after just being back for a couple of months now to the game, and she'll have to settle down a little bit here.
Well, we see a move right now by Sandra to set up the possibility of a second point or by throwing up a corner guard when the rock rolled out.
Short. 4 foot. Top eight.
Maybe I should explain a little bit what I meant in my opening comments as well, as far as how it's very tough to judge the sweeping on these, because it looks like they're going to stop, Lynn, or it looks like they're going to slow up, but in talking to Jane Hooper Perot before, she's ready. It's so slick, they just keep sliding and sliding.
And,
you know, you think it's going to stop, but it just doesn't, so you have to be so careful. Looking for a roll here.
Okay.
Have to be careful with takeout weight as well. Sometimes you step that up a little bit because, again, the surface is good and you don't mean to throw it quite so hard, and it will go that much straighter. So another chance to get up a front rock.
Marilyn's going to defend against this corner guard by playing a stone on the center line just short. She wants Corey Beveridge to stop this stone about 4, 5, 6, 7 inches. Now the front ends that can do that on a consistent basis will dictate the flow of the game.
Right here.
Here's the call by Marilyn.
Come on. Right up hard. Come on. Good sweeping, guys.
Nice shot.
Shot, Corey.
You bet it's a good shot.
A little bit more weight.
Joan McCusker, as we play in the first end of this opening draw of the Scott Tournament of Hearts from the Agrodome in Vancouver, Saskatchewan, and Team Canada. Team from the Kelley Curling Club, the Caledonian Curling Club in Regina, with the hammer here in this first end.
We've had a chance in our viewers across the country, we've had a chance to see a lot of these teams over the years, so they know their characteristics. And you take a team like Sandra Schmirler's, you know Joan McCusker, she's never out of the game. She's the pepper pot kind of, she keeps everybody alert out there. And those kind of things, those kind of combinations are so important. And each team, you know, will have an individual or two that kind of, they play different roles. Why one team wins and one team doesn't is always an interesting study as far as I'm concerned, because it's the chemistry, whether it be curling, basketball, football, baseball, doesn't matter what it is. It's a combination of personalities. It's a team game. And that word team really is a key.
And a combination that's worked so well is Jan Betker and Sandra Schmirler. We've seen them in world championship play, but it's not easy to form that back end unit. And you mentioned that in the opening, how key that can be. And there are so many great ones here, but this is one of them.
Yeah. Hurry.
For sure, that's clear.
Looking for the roll behind that corner guard covering the edge of the eight. Just a reminder, you can contact us on the internet. Your questions, comments, always appreciated. Curling at tsn.ca.
Yep.
You look across the sheets just quickly, and everybody, all the rings are kind of empty of stones, Linda. So I think it's as you mentioned, it's very common for the teams to play pretty wide open the first couple ends to get the feel for everything. There's the indication. Jan Betker, hit and roll behind the corner. A roll here can set up an extra point. That's why the corner was thrown up.
Yep. Whoa. Yes.
Whoa.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes. Hurry.
Gets a little closer.
That's one of the characteristics you will remember. I'm sure our viewers remember about this particular team. It's so often that Jan is yelling whoa or go, and Sandra's yelling the opposite there. You'll see a lot of that.
It is tough on the sweepers, but one thing about this ice, if we continue to see the swing, the anticipation of the sweeping, calling it early is going to be important, especially on those hits and rolls.
If she noses this, do we want to go behind it?
No, I think we're good. Everybody hitting and rolling to the open side. You can roll in off it.
So thinking a shot ahead, what's her thought here, Linda, in terms of this, if Marilyn does nose it?
Well, the rock is going to be outside the rings, and so they could be aggressive and use it as a guard, but Jan just saying, I think it's a little too early to do that. So they'll probably make a play on this if it sits anywhere in that area.
Yep.
Whoa.
Stay with it, Jane. Right over. Good shot.
Good shot by Marilyn to force the play away from the corner.
Yep.
Something else we should mention. This is also one of the qualifying spots for this fall's Olympic tournament. Marilyn Bodogh will already be there. Sandra Schmirler will already be there. So we know you could possibly potentially finish maybe third, fourth in this field, Linda, Ray, and still get the spot because people have already qualified.
Fifth, I think, too. Couldn't you finish fifth?
That's right. There are four teams here that have qualified, and if that happened, they might have to have a special playoff for that berth. Now, the odds of that happening, of course, are not great. But definitely these two teams have already qualified for that playdown in Brandon in November.
So if you're one of those teams, first stone for Sandra Schmirler, if you're one of those teams middle of the pack, come the end of the week, realizing the playoffs might be out of reach. But there's still the Olympics and a possible spot in the qualifier that you're playing for.
So there's the teams that have already qualified either through Scott Tournament of Hearts play, Bonsfield play, over the course of the season, curling tour points. And you can see that the ones here are Marilyn, Sandra, Kathy, and Kelley. All have qualified thus far for that playoff in Brandon.
So the fifth place finisher here, potentially, unless they need a playoff, could get a spot in Brandon come November.
Mary Manitol is here as the fifth for Nova Scotia. And she also, as you notice on the screen, she has a spot as well. So she's here playing fifth for Colleen Jones.
Final stone for the Team Canada skip. Marilyn Bodogh here in this first end, wide open end. Saskatchewan does have hammer.
Long roll, right over. Right over.
A good call by Kim, and a nice shot.
Very nice roll.
See that big long roll.
And she's just complimenting Kim on that. She didn't see it. She said,
"So normal, there. I think."
Yeah.
Normal weight.
We'll try and blank it.
Kept going and going.
No, house is pretty lively then.
Yeah, it feels pretty frosty though.
Yeah.
Does that happen, Ray? Can you be, can you in fact get frosty ice and still lively house?
Well, it just feels a little bit frosty under their feet. I don't see, you'll see it start to mark a little bit, but it is lively. It's very slick, as I mentioned in my opening comments, and the rocks will, you know, they'll go a long way. You catch a corner and they'll roll right across the rings. They were surprised at that. Sandra's routine, she'll clean that stone, stand and reset.
We take one.
In her fifth appearance, the final stone, first in for Sandra Schmirler.
Hurry!
Okay, that's good.
Catch a corner.
Atta girl.
Very nice to roll the shooter and blank this first end of play. So Saskatchewan maintains control of last draw. The first draw of the 1997 Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Good job, guys.
Nice. Geez, that didn't move at all, did it?
What is Kellogg's Mueslix? Mueslix cereal has home-baked tastes like delicious apple crisp. Mueslix is an abundance of textures, ingredients like crispy flakes of whole grain, flavors of fruit, cascades of nuts and crunchy granola. We bring you Kellogg's Mueslix. Wake up to home-baked taste.
small window to a new digital world.
When the Hendrick team switched to Quaker State this year, I was talking with my crew chief about it, and he said they ran through all these tests. The dyno, camshaft test, and the stuff beats all their standards. So I said, but don't forget, we won 8 races with last year's oil. And he said, yeah, but don't you forget, we also lost 24. Tough crowd.
Get your own special Quaker State NHL Cool Collectibles catalog when you buy your case of Quaker State Motor Oil, the official motor oil sponsor of the NHL.
In a clinic like this, I can't stop for a headache. The doctor here told me about Advil. It's tough on pain, and it really works fast. In fact, one Advil is so effective, one is often enough. And for cold and sinus congestion, there's Advil Cold and Sinus. It's tough on colds, like Advil is on pain. And now it's available without a prescription.
Advil and Advil Cold and Sinus. Tough on pain, tough on cold congestion.
Looking across the harbor here in Vancouver on a beautiful day, the opening day of the Scott Tournament of Hearts. We've completed one end in this first draw. And British Columbia has taken one, so Kelley Owen from Richmond opens with a single against Laura Phillips. PEI in Alberta, they blank. Alberta with hammer there. New Brunswick, Heidi Hanlon maintains control of last rock against Chantal Osborne from Buckingham, Quebec. From the Agrodome, our featured game, both two-time world champions, Team Canada, the defending champions Marilyn Bodogh, Saskatchewan's Sandra Schmirler. Saskatchewan blanking the end to maintain control of last rock. One stone already played by Team Canada, and this is the Saskatchewan lead. Marcia Goodright.
Well, I think, Linda, that the team's really, you know, it's pre-designed to kind of play the first couple ends wide open, but also what kind of causes that is the quickness of the ice surface, because it's, you really have to, those leads in particular, have to drive into their minds that it really is 25, 25 plus. And to get a rock in front of the rings, you have to come out of there so softly.
That's right, and they're trying to get the guards tight to the house. They don't want to leave up the long guard to leave the come around. And so you're thinking can't be too light and not finding the ranges yet.
I'm waiting for Jane. Tell her to get ready.
Okay. Just a little reminder about the time clocks. Of course, 73 minutes plus 2 timeouts for the game. And Marilyn just saying, now I've got to get back in that routine, remembering the time clocks, getting ready in the hack so that the skip isn't waiting to call the shot.
Hurry! No roll, Jan. No roll.
Sit.
Shot, Mars. Nice shot.
And it will sit, tee line, edge of the 12.
And they're always ticking away, just above your head, and always those time clocks are in your mind, so it's enough time, it's lots of time, as long as you don't waste the time preparing to throw. You've got time to call the game and throw the shots, you just can't waste any.
Just clean,
well,
clean,
it's really
clean,
one of the
clean.
Huge pluses to curling, in my
shot
opinion,
clean.
Nowadays, obviously it was the you know, for television alone, it's a tremendous thing because you can program it properly. But, you know, I can remember years ago, Linda, I mean, back even before your playing days, where, you know, there were some players that were notorious. And you'd see four and a half, five-hour curling games, which was just ridiculous, you know, to make up your mind, especially in those days when there was a lot of hitting involved. But it's a tremendous, tremendous thing. And it really has... And as you say, there's lots of time, Vic. There's no reason, no problem.
73 minutes is your time on the clock, as well as each team is allowed 2 1-minute timeouts that they can use.
12 and a half. Whoa. Clean.
Whoa.
Just clean.
Whoa.
Whoa, whoa.
Nice shot.
Atta girl.
From Cheryl McIntyre in Halifax, what team could be considered the dark horse at this week's Scott Tournament of Hearts?
Well, there's so many experienced teams, it's really hard to pick that out. I suggested maybe Ontario could even be considered that. Allison Goring, of course, is a former champion in 1990, but her team is new. Mary Bowman was with her in 95, but two new players, so I consider them maybe a bit of a dark horse.
Yeah, there's so many, as you mentioned, Linda. You know, I think, quite frankly, Laura Phillips could be one as well. And Laura does have lots of experience on her team, and she's, you know, got a lot of experience here. 24 hearts. No. I think they have more hearts than anybody else here, actually. They could certainly be, and Laura's been very close before. So that's one team to watch.
Right out.
Okay.
Janet Harvey, of course, has been here before, and Debbie Jones-Walker is a world champion, having played with you. So that's a team with some experience, but their front end never has been here. So, you know, those are the kind of things that you consider, I guess, when you talk about a dark horse.
Okay.
I'm mentioning Allison Goring, too. She is one of those very streaky curlers, as you very well know, Vic, because living in southern Ontario. And you know, she didn't really have a great season. They said they had a fun season, but all of a sudden they just got it going. And boy, I guess, and that's a tough province, as many of them are, to get out of.
It's a bit of an example of what we're talking about.
That's good, John.
Allison had the benefit of being in a backdoor event to get to the provincials. Is that not right, Vic?
That's right.
So her play at the district level was very close to provincials, so she got on one of those rolls, and that's what I'm suggesting Team Canada might be missing, just that feel that you've got the control and got the weight and all the things that come when you get on that kind of roll. Certainly full of talent, this team.
Line's getting closer.
Kim Gillard.
Our viewers can watch closely. Watch how it slides. It looks like it's going to come to a stop. But look at it go.
That's
listen. Listen to them. They wanted that rock short of the rings, just in front, that 6, 8, 10 inch area. That's control zone area we talk about, Linda.
Blocking the path to the forefoot. And once it slides in, it gives Jan a chance to hit and roll behind the corner guard that's placed. It's a little wide, the corner guard, but it's certainly accessible to be used.
Jan Betker here in this second end after a blank in one. Boy, is that an indication, too, now, that if you up the weight just a little bit, now, we don't know if she was outside, but if you up the weight, will they run that much straighter?
Well, there's no question that that's the physics of the whole thing. The more weight you throw, the less curl you're going to get. But I mentioned before, outside it was usually about 2 inches, and with the normal weight, I think that was maybe above their normal weight.
It just didn't go anywhere. No. That's pretty stupid.
What's the draws? What was that one?
It's normal.
About 2 feet off, though.
So from that, you get the sense she just overthrew it?
Overthrew it, and maybe it went straighter than they thought. Sandra prefers to play from the inside out on hits, and that one she had to play outside in because it was so close to center line. There is no other option, really.
Skip Stones here in two, and a chance now for Team Canada possibly set up the steal.
Go for line. Where is it? Split? Yep. Three.
Playing the split.
Hurry! Take it, Jane. Right over. Shot.
Well, it's another good call to try and get separation when the rock was heavy.
Right from my hand, eh?
Yeah, Marilyn just drove out too fast.
I don't want to take that O-turn at it.
No.
Even if I hit it and just roll into here, it's fine.
What, you're still a normal weight, though?
I'll throw it up a bit.
Yeah, there's what I was referring to. The other one, the Jan Betker shot, was the out turn, playing from the outside in. They're going to try it now from center line side because they just don't know really what happened, what went wrong.
If I throw it up and hit, there's also a hit and roll to corner freeze, too. Gotta save the shooter. That's right.
Hit and corner freeze, she says. Roll over into this area here.
I'll throw it up a bit.
Sandra Schmirler, native of Bigger, Saskatchewan, and her first stone here in two.
Yep. Yep. Yes! Hard! Hurry!
Whoa, watch it. Whoa.
That's fine.
Okay.
Good shot.
We got a chance to drive too, Bigger, did we not, on the way from Kindersley, Victor?
We did,
this
yep.
year. Had a great time there, of course, Kindersley, Saskatchewan.
13. Yep. Right on the nose.
Detail mixed. It was very beautiful when we were there.
It was. Absolutely.
You like this ice? On the nose, eh?
Kim Gillard holding the brush. Already we've seen, you know, we were all very impressed with her last year, coming off her World Junior experience. Showed a lot of confidence, knowledge already today. You know, when she got that long roll, she saw that. She saw that Marilyn was heavy with her first one, played the split. Continue to impress you?
Yeah, she's great in the house. Just a top-notch player.
Whoa! Yep!
Marilyn's trying to nose hit this so Sandra can't then hit either stone and be shot.
It's firm, eh? Shot!
There you go. She'll have to get a hit and roll to get shot stone.
Yeah. 12 and a half, eh? Yeah. 12?
That was
big weight.
Yeah.
We don't have any of these out tuning practice Joan through here, did you not?
Once again, to repeat what Linda said, she likes to play from the inside out, so that's from the center line out, and she'll try and get the roll into this area here and take her single.
Is this gonna move here? Oh, is it? Might need a little roll inside. Mm-hmm. Boy, not a lot of ice this way. Okay. No, she only got what, that? No.
The first day, ice is always the topic, and it does change a little bit in the first day as well, so you just have to watch every rock and keep on top of it.
This inside-out shot, I'm surprised at her comments, because I know in practice this inside-out shot was moving about 6 to 8 inches. Now, it all depends on weight, of course, and she's thrown it up pretty well.
Final stone facing two, Sandra Schmirler. Looking for the hit and the inside roll.
Nice shot.
And there it is to catch the four. And so in this battle of two-time world champions, Sandra Schmirler opens with one here and two. Hammer belongs to Team Canada when we come back.
I don't think I'm gonna cheat.
This sports break is brought to you by Burger King, where you can get a delicious flame broiled double supreme cheeseburger for only $1.99.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to the TSN Newsroom. I'm Darren Detition with a sports break. Five games taking place in the National Hockey League this afternoon, including the Philadelphia Flyers and the Florida Panthers. Ed Jovanovski back for the Panthers. He'd missed the last 16 games, and in the first period, Jovanovski with a point shot. Dave Lowry swats it in with a stick. The goal was waved off. Later, Martin Straka cutting in. His backhander goes off Joel Otto's skate and into the net. That makes it 1-0 for Florida. That's currently the way it stands after 20 minutes of play. Meanwhile, Detroit and St. Louis also doing battle this afternoon. It's 1-0 after 20 minutes as the Red Wings have jumped out to an early lead in that hockey game. That'll do it for this update. We'll have another one for you in about an hour's time. We'll see you then.
This is the eighth and final game of the series. The game, a 5-all tie. Hands it on that wing. Here's a shot. Henderson made a wild stab work spell. Here's another shot. Right by the door.
Relive one of hockey's greatest moments with this 1997 silver dollar from the Royal Canadian Mint. Order now. Call 1-800-267-7000.
You're all-stars, performing all-star feats. They're the reason we make the new 98 WinStar with the most powerful engine in its class, plus over 40 standard safety features. In fact, WinStar is the only minivan to earn 5 stars, the highest rating in U.S. government front-end crash tests. A pretty spectacular feat in itself. The new 98 Ford WinStar, created for the most important people in the world.
An update for you. This first round, second end, New Brunswick and Quebec after a blank in one. Heidi Hanlon with the hammer. Heidi, the champion of the Thistle St. Andrews Curling Club in St. John against Chantel Osborne from Buckingham. By the guard, looking to hit and roll out as well, but it'll stop back 12. New Brunswick's on the board. Quebec has last rock playing three. Saskatchewan takes one in the second, so Team Canada for the first time. Marilyn Bodogh has last rock as we begin play in the third.
Sandra threw it right into the rings, into the top 4-foot area, the control zone area. And,
it's sweeping, guys.
And as opposed to any offensive maneuver by
Hang on.
Marilyn, she hits it.
Okay, Jane.
And rolls
Same thing,
out.
Mars.
Marcia just, well, she says she's still on the maternity leave, having given birth to Colin just 2 months ago.
Good.
She works for Canadian Data Systems Limited.
There comes, coming down now. T-line's good. T-line's good.
Yeah, she's there.
Nice shot, Mars.
Nice wait, Mars.
When Jane Hooper-Perot finishes her maternity leave, conscious a lot of that going around, she'll return to the St. Clair Group as an art director.
It's catching too, Vic, so now that you're newly married.
Yeah, well, you got caught, yes, I know. But
I did get caught.
How are the boys?
The boys are
tight
great. Fit.
Good.
That's two open misses we've seen in this game so far. The one by Jan Beck, her last end, and then this one just now by Jane. Maybe just an indication that it is that much straighter with that extra weight, and maybe just a little bit straighter today as opposed to in practice.
I watched the sheet closely in the practice session, and it definitely was coming a couple inches, but that's, you're right, two outside in shots that, the trouble with the straight turn always, whether anywhere you go, is if you do, when they do run straight like that, if you do in any fashion put it back in any way and up the weight, the combination of those two is deadly. But you don't expect the wide openness from
12
teams of this level. But it certainly happens. That's too tight, so there's a double there for Corey Beveridge.
Yep. Hey.
The engineering student at McMaster in Hamilton. The Team Canada second.
Shot, Corey.
Great shot.
That's okay, just pulled it out. That's all.
Did you hear Linda? Sorry. She said you put it out. So Marilyn said to Jane, walk down and around,
please,
and just said something to Marilyn. Marilyn said, oh, it's okay. You just put it out a little bit. So that's the indication. She put it back. In other words, when she released it, she put it back a bit. So it just, and it runs so straight anyway.
Those target lines are so critical. It means maybe you were sliding a little bit inside the target line and your hand corrected that, but corrections can be very tough. And you see how little ice these shots have, the outside in takeouts. Any movement of the hand outwards rather than cleanly up to the 12 o'clock position can get you in trouble.
Corey Beveridge.
Yep.
And nice does a nice shot. Job to squeeze that stone past that rock just outside the rings to avoid the jam. Jan Betker. Stephen was born 7 months ago, so she's being a mom right now, she says.
Whoa! Whoa, clean! Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa.
No, never.
That's good enough, Jan. Shot.
Well, we really haven't seen any rocks in play at all. And it's only the third in. I'm sure one of these teams will make a move pretty soon.
Kim studies sociology at Western University in London, Ontario. That's difficult too. And I mean, that we've seen that in other teams as well. They come together, they practice on their own in their respective cities where they happen to be. Their home club is the St. Catharines Curling Club, where
high is good.
Marilyn Bodogh makes her home, but then they get together and they bond spiel. That's not always easy. You need a commitment from all your players to do that.
No, it's not easy, and maybe one of the reasons why their bond spiel season hasn't been as easy for them, because coming together, you have to quickly put it together, as opposed to if you've been practicing together, it seems to flow that much more easily.
Good enough, Jen.
Whoa. Like, I know I'm heavy when I let it go. It's just a matter of coming with the weight.
Like that?
Yeah?
At this stage, throwing your last third Where's stone it? As the corner frees
Lots
the shot here.
Well, that's the only
room.
Rock in, that's in play as a rock just outside the ring, so you might as well throw
Lots
down in front of it. You got the advantage of last rock, and
Lots of room.
You're looking just to, trying to angle Coming freeze down. On it. Absolutely, this is the
corner
shot to play.
Frozen.
Look at this
corner
walk
frozen.
Over, too.
Whoa. Shot.
Just, if it comes another inch, it's absolutely
okay.
perfect.
You can take it off because you're shooting anyway, honey.
Oh, right. Okay. yeah. Guess I can throw the intern, eh?
So no, it'll be good. Cause
find it any heavier out here?
Just no. for those of you that, I mean, for those of you that curl, I'm sure you understand what I was talking about, but just for those of you that may not do a lot of curling, what we were trying to do with this stone here, and I'll just clear that for a moment, is
There's
put
no
it on
there.
An angle right there
really, like,
on the face of
them.
That stone so that then this hit too. Becomes very difficult. Yeah. If you get the jam,
yeah,
and then
we'll shoot them there, but I like
you
this.
Might set up the possibility of 2 points.
Nose would be great.
Yeah.
Any heavier out there?
The Southeast
really.
Leisure Center.
Really.
In Regina. She loves all kinds of sports. Sandra.
Well, yep. Yes! Hurry! Quick! Hurry, quick!
Right on the nose, That's she good. Said would be perfect.
Good shot.
She was hoping to stay a little bit closer to that red stone, making her rock, the yellow stone, more difficult to remove.
So, once again, a little attempt at what Marilyn will try and do is hit this stone. I'll clear that for you. And roll right over here in front of this stone, making it difficult for Sandra to get at it.
Team Canada with last rock, the hammer here in this third
stone
end, 12. And trailing 1-0 to Saskatchewan.
You can't get a little... Sneaky little hit and roll, huh?
There it is.
She manages the family lumber business, Bodogh Lumber in St. Catharines, and
yes,
has
yes.
become quite an accomplished Fire. Public speaker
Hurry
as well.
Hurry all the way
Hurry!
Hurry! Hurry!
Great sweeping. Right up.
Hey, Marilyn.
Can't hold the shooter.
Sitting over here?
Yeah.
She threw it really, really tight.
Okay, that should be good.
So a chance for Sandra to check out the side ice, withdraw weight, try and
what do you
draw
think?
A stone in front of that red
it's
one.
The same. Same team stuff, eh?
Always
we can probably take last, Jan. Yeah, Kim really dumped hers, so.
Always lots of information, and you'll hear Sandra talk so often with her front end, but particularly with Joan McCusker.
Yeah. As long as we're in the rings.
And she talked about Kim, obviously Kim Gillard dumping hers.
Mm-hmm. Starting it, yep.
Kim was inside the target line, and so they couldn't get a read off how much it would curl, so
okay,
she's cut
around.
Down the ice from where she thought it
Whoa,
might
if
be.
You can.
Look.
Take a look. Look, guys.
Whoa.
You heard Joan
okay,
say
just
it's just
it.
As quick
Line's
out
okay.
there, Sandra, as it is
Whoa.
Anywhere on the
Whoa,
ice.
Whoa, if you can. But
Whoa, if you can.
Whoa, if you can.
Whoa, if you can.
Whoa, if you can.
No.
Whoa.
Nice weight.
Boy, look at it go.
Yeah, that's what I meant about the sliding, the slickness. It's really hard to, that really looked like it was just going to stop dead, didn't it?
Feel it this way?
Just keeps yep. going.
Yeah, just Need slid that ice. Much too far.
Okay.
So the rocks huh? are side by side.
Well, it just looked like it was going to be, like, be really long, or just, like, sit out, and then it just, there's a little hill, and it just falls off the hill.
A little hill, eh?
I'm gonna throw a peel. Like a positive 12.
Both Marilyn and Sandra are very similar in their sets. They clean the rock, they get down, then they get up, and then down Whoa. They go and ready to throw.
Yep.
I like it, quite frankly. I think it's a It's a good way to refocus once the stone's cleaned.
Final stone, looking to blank if she can.
Okay.
And she got caught on her own stone.
That's what she wanted the first time.
One red.
Team Canada and Marilyn Bodogh forced to take one.
Yeah,
and so we're all even after 3-1-1 in this opening draw, the Scott Tournament of Hearts. From Vancouver. Look what I laid.
Psoriasis, seborrheic dermatitis, dandruff. Symptom, persistent, itchy, flaky scalp. Solution, Neutrogena T-Gel. It works. Neutrogena T-Gel Shampoo.
We make maple leaf wieners for Courtney, who will only eat Mr. Broccoli if he hasn't touched Mr. Gravy. We make maple leaf wieners for Tim, who says peas explode in his mouth. And for Caitlin, whose scrambled eggs must be shaped like little boats. Maple leaf wieners have a taste made especially for kids. For Kenny, who won't eat anything with sauce, and Jason, who won't eat anything without sauce, there will always be maple leaf.
Maybe you think only those jet set types need a Nokia cellular phone.
Hi, it's me. Flight's delayed.
Well, now Nokia's making cellular phones so easy.
Lately. Can I skip my bath?
They're practically child's play.
Attention, flight 11 is delayed.
Can I call you back?
With Nokia's big, easy-to-read screens, last number redial, and sleek designs.
No, don't hold dinner. I'm eating my body weight in hot dogs. No, wait up. You gotta tuck me in.
So get set to join the jet set. Nokia, Europe's leading cellular phone, also made in America. Connecting people.
Let me understand this. If I'm in the middle of shooting, and you yell car, then the goal doesn't count.
That's the rule.
But I already took the shot.
Doesn't matter.
But I already took the shot.
That's the rule. I didn't make it up.
So what do you think, in the NHL they yell car? Real goalies don't yell car.
What? I can't believe you finished them.
I'm sorry, buddy. That's the rules. I didn't make them up.
Kellogg's Frosted Flakes cereal for kids of all ages. They're great.
Dad, did you have any friends when you were a kid?
The pain of arthritis and joint stiffness can get the better of many people. So today, there's coated extra strength aspirin with the power to relieve your worst pain right where it hurts. Aspirin, it really knows your pain.
Welcome back to the Agrodome in Vancouver. A live update for you. Third end of play, New Brunswick against Quebec. New Brunswick leading 1-0. And this is the final stone for the Quebec skip, Chantal Osborne from the Buckingham Curling Club. Has a chance here, Ray Linda, to play the split 4-3 after Heidi Hanlon from the Thistle St. Andrews threw her last stone through.
Trying to catch the corner of the rock and roll it in. Good contact with the first one, but can't roll it far enough.
So Quebec will pick up two in the third and take a 2-1 lead over Heidi Hanlon. Chantal Osborne has been here before, as have all the skips in this year's Scott Tournament of Hearts.
With the house being so lively, those kind of shots are very makeable, Linda. You know, you get lots of action. They had to brush that, actually, just to hit it a little thinner, and she would have got her three.
From one side of the Agrodome to this side now in our featured game in the first draw, Team Canada. Marilyn Bodogh picking up 1-3 to even it at 1-1 now as we play the fourth. Saskatchewan does have the hammer. This is the Saskatchewan lead, Marcia Gooderite.
It's a very defensive game so far. Nobody prepared to take any kind of a chance. Marilyn, in this case, having scored her single, bringing the rock to the rings.
Hard, hurry.
Exchange of stones, so you're not going to see a lot of offense.
That'll work. Jeez, it's so frosty out there.
They're talking about frost, but the first day is hard to know. The ice hasn't been played a lot, and you get a lot of shine in the center that makes it look like the outsides are frosty, but it's really hard to tell if that's what's happening.
Corey Beverly.
If there is some, Linda, it's not affecting the stone in any fashion. It may be making it run a little straighter on the outside end, that's all. But. Saw the outside in shot, now you see the inside out shot. The intern in this case from Joan McCusker.
Hurry! Gotta go, guys. Gotta go. Hurry hard. Hold it there. Good shot. Good sweeping, you guys.
Both teams have very good sweeping. They're positioned on opposite sides of the stone, getting close to the stone and close to each other.
That's good then. That's good.
So well thrown, but also well swept.
Whoa. Whoa. 12 and a half. 12.
Marilyn took on the inside of the stone, so it's running very, very straight, this shot, this outturn, this outside in shot.
Atta girl. Shot.
And that is a little bit different from practice. It wasn't coming much, but it was coming more than that. So a little bit of frost buildup, possibly, and a little bit more, the temperature being a little warmer, it just seemed to straighten up a little bit.
Joan McCusker, you do sense, though, they like to or think that maybe mistakes can be made on the edges, and because we're seeing a lot of that play to the edges. Agree?
Well, I really think, Vic, that they just haven't tried anything, okay? So we really haven't seen, we've seen a couple of misses, but they haven't, neither one of the teams in the with the last rock advantage have made any kind of a movement, similarly, the team without last rock hasn't thrown up any guards, so it's strictly been a defensive game.
That a girl. Some fun yet?
As we look at all the scores, Prince Edward Island is on the board. And we showed you the two scored by Quebec, Chantal Osborne, Jan Betker. Why do you think that is? Get inside their head here, Linda. Why would you not be more aggressive?
Well, we talked about why we expected it for a couple of ends, gaining confidence, getting the feel for the ice. Actually, some of these ends, what's happened, and Ray pointed it out early, Marilyn actually has been calling some guards, and they've been sliding into the house, and it's a rare occurrence this early in the tournament and this early in a game that you'll take big chances when they pull that first rock in. I think if we can see the teams get a better feel for that draw weight, plant a guard in front, then we're going to see somebody have to make a move.
No.
And they're not afraid of it. They just don't want to do it this early when the rocks are coming in.
Okay, real teams.
You've got to remember what we're talking about here. This is a huge matchup. We're talking about two-time world champions, both teams expected to be in contention, and neither one wants to make the big mistake in this game too early and feel like they're going to let it get away.
What do you got? Okay. Yep, hurry. Okay, just a bite's good. Just, no, right here, just here. No, whoa.
It's in the hallway.
It's good.
Good sweep, guys.
Roll it in. Yeah, 12 and a half.
So it's up and down the sheet here in this fourth end, and we're ready for Skip Stones, Marilyn Bodogh.
I talk a lot about getting used to the ice, and part of the reason is an arena has different ice surface, and the stones are a little bit different. They're designed a little bit for getting some movement on arena ice. So you can't automatically say these teams come from curling ice and suddenly feel comfortable on this arena ice. They have to get the feel under the slider as well as watching the stone come down the ice. So far, this building hasn't shown us much in the way of problems with air flows. The ice makers were saying they don't expect that to happen with this building. But the players can't really get that feel until they've got a game under their belt.
It's nice. Good shot. Yeah, a little roll out is good. Nose is good.
Well, the Agrodome is slated for demolition this summer as they do some renovation work here at the PNE grounds. The ceiling is round, and maybe it's for that reason that they don't expect anything. It's, as you can see, unlike most buildings we've been in, arenas which have the more square roofs, sometimes we've seen, in fact, drafts occurring. Maybe it's because of this. There are none. It's more generally equally distributed. Seats around 3,000.
Well, one of the things that Hans Butrick, the head ice technician, said to Ray and I is he sort of laughed that there isn't a huge problem with the airflow because there is no built-in air conditioning. Some of the newer buildings have air conditioning blowing the heat down onto the ice surface, and we have to worry about that. But Ray, it's just not that factor here.
No, for sure. And there'd be a lot of areas in the country that would love to have this building.
Yes.
I can tell you.
Okay, that's good. Nice shot.
Very nice.
She knows it's looking at
As we look across the four sheets, all the games are in the fourth end of play.
Of course, our game on sheet A is going very quickly because of the style of play we're seeing, wide open. And as we look across, there have been some blank ends on the other sheet, which gives us the feeling that a lot of them have been more takeout style and thus quite fast.
And that's certainly the indication if you look at the scoreboards across the many sheets. We haven't seen many rocks in play.
Well,
final stone for Team Canada here in four. Saskatchewan does have hammer.
Yep. Hurry. Hurry. Nice shot, Marilyn.
And sits it right on the edge of the 12.
Or high, hey? Right?
Wait, that's a little bit less ice than you had.
Is it? Oh, I'll take a little more then. If I roll, will I roll on?
No.
Can blanket by nose hitting because the stone isn't
thing.
Fully in the house, or an outside roll towards the boards.
Yeah, this is the better end to do it at too.
Nice. Steal five.
So thinking ahead.
Fast. Just been up and down the sheet.
Yeah. We know that. Okay. We've been watching that. But thinking of something, is she saying maybe if we can do something to steal five? Depending if Saskatchewan can blank here, she may have the hammer back. Final stone for Sandra Schmirler.
Okay, that's good. That's fine.
The nose hit, good enough, and she actually gets a little bit of a roll away to blank this fourth end of a wide open game. Canada, Saskatchewan are even at one apiece, and Sandra Schmirler maintains control of last rock when we come back to Vancouver.
Five.
You probably miss breakfast too. Kellogg's Nutri-Grain cereal bar is part of a complete breakfast. Good food on the go.
You didn't tell me.
You never asked.
But I thought we had everything in common.
We do. We're both great tasting, except that I'm low in fat.
Low in fat?
Yeah.
You say it like it's no big deal.
Kellogg's Rice Krispie Squares have always been low in fat. Hey, now you know.
Who'd have guessed?
I don't do my taxes. I haven't done them in 5 years. And I'm not going to do them again. I'm not losing any sleep over it. I lost more sleep when I did my taxes. Revenue Canada, they don't scare me. I got a system. It's guaranteed.
I think Ford has had its best successes when we've gone in our own direction. This is why we've given the Canadian car buyer a choice between the Taurus sedan or wagon at the same very affordable price. So they can choose the Taurus that meets their individual needs. Sedan or wagon. It's an original idea. It's a good idea.
Ford of Canada, providing choice for Canadians.
Deli shaved Black Forest ham, oven roasted turkey and chicken. Assorted sub.
Popular downtown deli or the Winklers on Maple Street. Introducing the new and improved taste of maple leaf sandwich meats that will turn your home into a deli. Deli shaved Black Forest ham, oven roasted turkey and chicken. Sub Express with ham bologna and summer sausage.
You forgot the mustard on table 7.
And you forgot your check.
New maple leaf sandwich meats. Taste that's a cut above.
The monument and statue to Harry Jerome, who called Vancouver home. It stands in Stanley Park. Not quite as fast as Mr. Jerome, but maybe one day. Enjoying the opening day of the Scott Tournament of Hearts here in Vancouver, the Agrodome. And after the blank in four, we remain tied 1-1, Saskatchewan with last rock. And there's the center line guard. So we have one out in front.
And Sanders going around it.
Line's good.
Looks like T-line.
The defensive play, of course, if she wanted to stay on the defense, which, you know, I don't think she should, but it would be to go to the open side, try and draw the play away from it, maybe get a roll out, and you can peel it off. But the offensive move is to go around it.
Gee, the weight was pretty good. It came down.
The numbers through four And Marcy Gooderite has been perfect to that point. Now, how would they scored that, in fact, do you think, Linda? Maybe she called for the come around, but she...
Well, a come around top 8 foot would be 4 out of 4. But that's not a bad shot because she did split the guard off center line. So now it's a judgment call by the person scoring the sheet, and it might be a 2.
Or a 1.
I'm giving it a 1, and Linda's giving it a 2. And
you're pretty tough on those leads, Ray. I thought you'd be a little easier on them.
Great shot.
Well, no, I just expect a lot from them.
Up to your standard.
I couldn't say that, of course.
Well, it's interesting. We go from hardly a rock in play, now 3 thrown and 3 in front.
And after the third stone of the end has come to rest, you can start removing those guards. And that's what Sandra's trying to do because the path to the 4 foot is getting a little blocked.
Shot, Mars.
Got a girl.
Mary's gonna put it back.
One again or this?
I can't draw.
12 and a half.
She was gonna play the guard, but she's gonna play the hit and roll and try and roll to the center line. So both the stones out in front will be hers.
The numbers they use are timing the takeouts and draws from hog to tee. Obviously, in this case, it's hog to contact because the rock they're hitting is in front of the tee line. But they do time all their shots to try and get a standard weight amongst all the players.
Corey Beveridge.
No roll?
No roll.
Okay.
Like that?
I think so, yeah.
Wide open style of game is conducive to good numbers, and those certainly are good numbers.
In turn, come around. Sandra asking Joan McCusker.
Line's good.
Hey, weight's close.
Now the last one really finished big time, really, as you heard Sandra say, it really came down there, but this is staying out a little bit.
How many you got?
Back house.
Close? Close?
Back house.
Yeah.
Trying to play the tick now because of the extra weight. That's a good call. It was heavy, but you heard the communication, and so Joan ends up with a shot that's buried.
Yeah, she just overthrew it because that rock is going through the rings if it doesn't touch the front one. That is literally the rub of the green. Of course. Saskatchewan being the green team.
Big room?
Mm-hmm.
Just top 12. Lots of room, though. Ton of room. Okay, we're going 4 foot.
No.
Oh, yep. Come on.
Whoa.
Whoa, whoa.
Yeah,
whoa.
High's good, high's good.
Just didn't break.
Christina was born 9 months ago. Second child for Joan McCusker, who teaches
here,
school at the Elsie Moronic.
Okay, just throw a
She talked about a roll this way, and then she also mentioned maybe going rolling into this position here, so.
She looked at how much clearance there was between the right-hand guard and the rock, and she's just a little worried that it's straight and it won't move.
Hurry!
It's getting movement here.
Quick! Hurry, 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 right down, right down. No roll, Mars. No roll, no roll.
Wow. Suddenly it's become very aggressive, hasn't it?
See, she got that started. That was good brushing, in my opinion. It's a nice shot.
Right there.
I'm not criticizing the shot at all. Just that I think that that was the face that Joan gave you.
Okay.
I think she got that going a little bit, and the good brushing held it up.
Pretty much the only shot we have, eh? 12.
A little bit harder takeout. Trying to catch the outside corner of the one that's peeking out from behind the guard.
Yep.
Kim Gillard here in 5, a 1-1 tie. Saskatchewan has hammer in their line 2. Trying to sneak it by the guard. No.
Okay, Kim. Good sweeping.
Guard on those, I guess.
Like, we want to guard this, baby.
Okay.
I guess.
Not quite sure how to get right there, though.
Definitely want to guard them. The double's there, so.
That doesn't get you to the center line anymore.
No.
But does she have a good point? Does she make a good point, Sandra, in saying, I don't know how to get there?
Well, she said it's difficult to get there. Much?
Yeah.
Why is that, Linda?
She's still guessing a little bit. Center line seems to be straight, but it breaks once it gets off. And this one, she has to play the first part of the path down center.
Jan Becker.
Whoa, 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 guys.
Line's okay.
Tight.
Whoa. No, no, no.
Players are just having a lot of trouble pulling back on these shots, not driving out so hard from the hack.
You can't work it if it's too heavy. Well,
can you freeze that one?
Well,
no.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, that's okay.
I think the best way to hit it's on that side, eh? Sliding it up around.
You're gonna get them all, actually.
Right there!
Hit this one here. Well, I get Marin's kind of in the road.
Don't you think the other side, Cor? The board, this side?
Come back in here.
Get the double on.
Catch that one, possibly.
No, are they frozen? No. They're not frozen, are they? Then you have a chance of a triple.
I think that's the side.
Yeah, me too, because then want to take a run down? Take a run down.
Well, you call on the engineering student when you're looking at these.
Corey's the one with the angles.
If you hit it that side, this one.
That goes that.
You don't think that one?
It's where they're going to hit it. You want, what Corey is saying is hit it here.
Okay.
So this one, this rock here, will go this way, and you'll catch this one as you go by it. Push it that way.
Better throw peel then.
She can get all three.
Team Canada in a little bit of trouble here in this fifth of a 1-1 tie. Throwing peel. Here we go. 1-2. Oh, she jammed it. Had the idea, but got the jam, but it's in the open. Got rid of two.
That's a great shot. She got a little bit of a roll, which blocks off an easy path behind the other guard. Closes down the area that Sandra can play to.
Me too. Me too.
Just had to hold a little bit more, and she would have got all three of them.
It looked like the way from the hat.
Yeah. Just hit it. Just
but then.
Hit it a little thick and jammed it.
Like, this is not bad. It's not bad.
Can draw the.
What Linda's talking about is the roll
way,
over here.
Either way, you might hit the double. It doesn't matter which one you want to play.
Makes this come around difficult.
I don't really like coming deep down here, though.
Yeah. Okay, let's play a split.
All right, so we're going to play the split.
Only want this kind of weight, though. Back eight.
Push it over here and try and roll over into here.
The initial option they talked about was drawing deep into the house, but that would allow then Team Canada to hit the shot in the forefoot and roll in front of the other, thus making the Team Canada rock hard to remove. So they've opted to try and spread them out this other way, playing the split.
Also, by doing that, then they may set up the double too, which is.
Hands away!
Yeah, you can.
Yes!
Well, then if it's lots. Well, it's just going to tap it straight back.
Yes,
we don't have lots. Yeah, I can get shot this way too, eh?
Are we going for the double?
Well, hit and roll. If I get the double, good.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, hit and roll.
Yeah.
Talking about two things, I'll let them talk.
Right there. With a,
well. 12 and a half.
One was, they first discussed possibly making the double, but you heard Marilyn say, let's play the hit and roll, hitting this one and trying to roll over here into this area here behind the rocks out in front. But the double's always there.
Hit and roll.
Hit and roll. There you are.
She sensed a little, misjudgment here.
I'm just looking for the
Sandra
roll.
Thought that the front end maybe didn't call that properly for her.
It was curling too much, so there was the indecision between letting it come up and tap it straight back versus still trying to get some angle, and it certainly didn't work as well as they wanted it to.
Skip stones here in five. First for Team Canada, Marilyn Bodogh. Gets them both and gets a great roll.
There you go, guys.
And this is what Marilyn needs to get pumped, because she plays very well with emotion, and when she's got the confidence, and those kinds of shots are going to get her ready for the week.
Good comment, and it's so true.
And again, a great line call. They were watching the angle the whole way. The sweepers in position to sweep it if need be, just a total team shot.
Sure was, and that's what.
Still, it's a pretty good shot.
Well, yeah, pretty good shot. What Vic talked about earlier, that was a great call by Kim.
I might have
DeLarge.
An open shot. This way I might have a close. Well, I still have a full 4 foot putt.
Okay. Let's see what they think. I don't mind this.
I don't know what it does here.
This rock is very difficult to get at. And that was their discussion. So what they've done is.
How much of that one can you see?
Yeah, we can't hit that. What?
Well, there you are.
How much of that one can you see?
3/4? Had to be on Jan to get some split there. Didn't get any split.
Well, she's still thinking about Jan Bettger's last stone.
I might take a hair more.
If in fact, though, she says you can see 3/4 of that stone sitting in the 8 foot, why don't you play it?
Just have
not even.
You could touch it, but you couldn't stay off of it. Okay.
It's the same.
You can get to it. I don't think you can hit the stick off it.
Sandra knows that she's going to need this draw weight to make the key shot. She's going to try and find it here. She can get it buried. This is a good spot in the ice to learn from.
Roll it right over.
That was really interesting.
That's fine. The weight was good.
Because,
yeah, weight's good.
Wasn't the weight good?
You heard Kim say to Marilyn, I think I'd take more ice than she was taking. And that was obviously the case. They needed a little bit more ice. I think Sandra had a nice weight, perfect weight.
I thought
they
said the weight had lost.
Yeah, they did.
I think you're right. And again, if just finding that range, where to put the broom with that weight.
Like a little flop on center line, eh? 12 and a half.
Hit this, come right across here onto that one there, and you could be shot rock.
Well, she's actually just trying to hit and stay there.
Yep.
Trying to block down the path. But she's going to get a bit of a roll.
Okay.
She talked about maybe not rolling so far, just because then she, closes the area down.
You're absolutely right, Linda. She just wanted to roll to the center line to block off the draw. She stops a little shorter.
Yeah, right there.
Sandra still has to worry, of course.
That weight was okay, no more than that, though.
After watching the first one come down and break so hard.
No more than that.
What Linda was saying was absolutely correct. If she rolls into this area here, then this draw becomes much more difficult. Sandra just played a draw down here, and she's taking a little bit more ice, and she has the 4 foot. But you have to make them.
Any piece of the blue. But Sandra realizes that this end turned right around after that misjudgment on Jan Bettger's stone allowed Team Canada to now sit three as she throws her final stone.
Line's great. T line, guys. I think. Don't you think so?
Very slippery.
I think so, yeah. Hurry, guys. Hurry, guys.
Hurry. Oh, look at it walk over.
Hurry. Push hard. Come on, Lily. You go. It'll go. Come on. Push hard. Push hard.
Now that's great. Rushing it. They get it. There they do. Again, a little bit. bit of indecision among the front end of Marcy Gooderite and Joan McCusker, but they rushed it enough to get it there, and Saskatchewan has a 2-1 lead through five.
At Maple Leaf, when we reduced the fat in our new lean and light wieners and bologna, we tested the taste with families just like yours. We found we could reduce the fat by 60%, and lean and light would still have that mouth-watering Maple Leaf taste. Any less fat? Well then, we'd appeal to only some members of the family. The uncompromised great taste of new Maple Leaf lean and light. Taste that's a cut above.
Maybe you think only those fast lane types need a Nokia cellular phone.
Bill, Bob, I'm running late.
Well, now Nokia's making cellular phones so easy.
So, cover for me during finger paints?
They're practically child's play.
Hey, it's science day.
With Nokia's big screens, easy to find names and numbers, and sleek designs.
Cooch, could you handle sandbox for me? I'm like in a four-lane parking lot. We're talking rest period before I get there. Oh, I forgot my show and tell.
So now we can all be in the fast lane. Nokia, Europe's leading cellular phone, also made in America, connecting people.
When people hear the Hendrick Motorsports team switch to Quaker State this year, they'll probably think Quaker State wrote us a big check. Well, that's not how it happened. First, it had to pass our camshaft test. Then it had to pass our dyno test. Then it had to pass a track test. Then they wrote us the big check.
Look for the new Quaker State NHL Cool Collectibles catalog at all dealers displaying this sign. You can get great NHL league and team identified items when you have your oil changed with Quaker State, the official motor oil sponsor of the NHL.
Purex has gone to great lengths to give you a longer-lasting bathroom tissue. Purex Double Roll. With twice as many pillowy soft sheets on every roll, it takes forever to run out. Purex Double Roll. Pillowy softness that lasts twice as long.
Fifth end break and Team Canada. Kim Gillard, Corey Beveridge, Mary Gillard the coach. Time for a little orange break. Reiner, stay with us right after the game for the TSN Turning Point. Brought to you by Super 8.
Trying it too. Take it
It's always been my way or no way, right? So when I go away, I stay at Super 8. I want it comfortable. Am I right? I want my VIP discount and friendly people. But not too friendly. Life's great at Super 8.
Updating you on the game between Newfoundland and British Columbia as they play the fourth. British Columbia, Kelley Owen scored one with Hammer in the first. They blanked second and third. This is the final stone for the Newfoundland champion, Laura Phillips. Phillips out of the St. John's Curling Club makes the hit and stick at the back of the eight to score one. And so they're tied 1-1 playing five. And on sheet D, an update, fourth end, New Brunswick and Quebec. We saw Quebec, Chantal Osborne scored two in the third to take a 2-1 lead. This now the final stone for Heidi Hanlon from the Thistle St. Andrews Curling Club in St. John, New Brunswick. Scores two to regain the lead, 3-2, as Quebec plays with Last Rock in the fifth. And on sheet C, Prince Edward Island and Alberta, PEI scored one in three, they blanked four. And so Prince Edward Island has Hammer trailing Alberta 2-1. Anita Ford, the coach of Saskatchewan, little chat with Sandra Schmirler. She's up 2-1.
It's a big pressure to us.
The pain of arthritis and joint stiffness can get the better of many people. So today, there's coated extra strength aspirin with the power to relieve your worst pain right where it hurts. Aspirin, it really knows your pain.
We make maple leaf wieners for Courtney, who will only eat Mr. Broccoli if he hasn't touched Mr. Gravy. We make maple leaf wieners for Tim, who says peas explode in his mouth. And for Caitlin, whose scrambled eggs must be shaped like little boats. Maple leaf wieners have a taste made especially for kids. For Kenny, who won't eat anything with sauce, and Jason, who won't eat anything without sauce, there will always be maple leaf.
You can feel the cotton.
Your car is a high-precision instrument. Take it to AutoPro. With qualified personnel and state-of-the-art equipment, it's the expert on brakes, front-wheel drive, steering, suspension, and mufflers. All protected by AutoPro's national warranty. AutoPro, the largest network of car care professionals.
My nose is stubbed up, dry, and irritated too.
Otrivin. New Otrivin with moisturizers.
Live update for you. This is the game between Newfoundland and British Columbia as they play five. Newfoundland, line one, back four. Kelley Owen got to get by the guard. She gets the rub. As she had a difficult shot, Linda Ray, she had to get the curl to catch enough of the button for shot stone. And is it one, steal of one, or two? Steal of one?
It looked like one.
Steal of one for Newfoundland and Laura Phillips. So she'll take a 2-1 lead over British Columbia and the team from the Richmond Curling Club through five. But she made a great shot with her last stone. Laura Phillips got through the port, got the hit and roll behind cover, and then it was Kelley Owen left with her final draw that she could not make. We go to the sixth end here, Saskatchewan, with a 2-1 lead over Team Canada. And the defending champions, Marilyn Bodogh, have the hammer.
Well, Saskatchewan threw the first rock into the rings, and Marilyn went to throw up a corner guard, but it slipped into the rings as well, allowing Saskatchewan to hit it. So Marilyn now, as opposed to, looks to me, is, oh, she knows she's playing the corner guard again. You can see her indicate. Calling for a rock out in front.
6-8-2-4. Well, they played a great last end. Some very key angles. Remember how well Saskatchewan was sitting in that last end until some lovely doubles were made.
Oh, it's coming down.
By Team Canada. So they're trying to get some play going this end with last rock advantage.
Come on down. KJ, shot.
This stone can be hit now. You can see it didn't take Sandra very long to. That's why the corner guard with the first stone is so important, the one that's lifted into the rings, because it could not be removed. Sandra's running up and playing the peel. She'll try and roll over in front of the stone, sitting in the forefoot, just biting the button.
Watch your roll. Just roll it in. Yep. As long as it's in. As long as it's in. Got a
girl.
Shot,
very
Jill.
Nice.
Did anyone hit the top one?
12 and a
half! No?
Hit this here and try and roll into this area here behind this rock.
Yes! Hurry! Hurry!
Corey Beveridge. Jane Hooper-Perot closest to the stone. Kim Gillard out in front.
Hurry!
Oh, jeez.
Way inside. Okay, Corey.
I don't have to say much more about that.
Joan McCusker.
Now play the intern draw and try and separate their stones, keeping them in the house and
T-line.
Hoping Team Canada can't hit and get a good roll.
Can't be deep here. Can't be deep. Shot, Joan.
Had a girl. Very nice. Hit and roll on the top one.
Yep. 12. No. Never. Not even close. Corey.
That's easy to say from up here, but it looks to me like Corey's got the rock a little bit more to the side than normal, and she's getting them, that means, to the right of the target here, line. Right? Just couldn't curl enough to make the
right
shot.
There. What'd she say? Yeah, we gotta go here.
Yeah.
Spread them out, says Sandra Schmirler. So, Ray, when you do that, when you do have the stone not out in front, what do you end up usually doing?
Well, you're throwing it from a different angle, and you can, you know, and sometimes what you do is you'll attempt to put it back on the target line. And if you do that, you're rolling them over. And as Linda said, she doesn't have a tendency to roll the stone, so she's just coming out a little full of the target on the line.
Buggers.
Good shot.
Kim Gillard, yep. You talked about 25 second ice. They talk now 12 and a half. Why?
We're talking ticket weight from mark to tee. And the other one is the draw weight, which of course takes a lot longer to go down the ice. Just about twice as long, as a matter of fact.
Okay, let's hit the stick here. Yeah. We know what this intern's gonna do.
We know this, hey?
Yeah.
Goes pretty straight.
And we talked about how Marilyn likes to play the Team Canada skip. She likes to play aggressively, likes to come arounds. I think Sandra, Ray, would mind this kind of game, keeping it more open. Sandra's team is very strong on the takeout style game, and they probably don't mind to leave it a little longer before they become more aggressive.
No, I agree. I think that there's no question that Sandra...
Nice shot.
Not that she prefers to play the defense, but she leans towards it a little bit, you know. And where Marilyn does, well, you saw the attempt to throw off the corner, which came into the rings, which changed the end.
Sure.
That corner guard, Jane's corner guard stays out, her first stone, then this end could be quite a bit different.
Through five, brought to you by AT&T Canada.
Well, fairly unusual. It's a low-scoring game, more wide open. Sandra Schmirler's had a chance to blank a couple of ends. She's leading by the 1 point. The numbers are pretty good, but with a wide-open style of game, we haven't seen people have to make key draws. You do see Saskatchewan has the edge on draw weight, a little bit of edge to Team Canada on hits, and an edge for Saskatchewan overall on the team percentage, but we haven't seen a lot from these teams yet. A little bit more last end, and that's when you really start to see how the players are performing.
Can we use a little more ice here, maybe?
Well, nice draw by Sandra last end, and if Marilyn, as you suggested and pointed out, when
maybe
I was
a touch more.
Dreaming a little there, that if Marilyn doesn't get that roll right across and rolls to the center line, that draw that Sandra made is much more difficult.
The other thing too, as we were away, you pointed out how quickly that stone walks over. They really had to brush it, not only for the weight, but just to hold the curl.
Yeah.
Turn and roll the other way.
Right over.
Oh, nice shot. Another girl.
Like looking in a mirror.
And roll.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Like hit and roll over start
close to the other one as we can. Both? And a half? Yeah, in between there. Both these teams have this first draw by the 1990 Canadian champion. Allison Goring returns from Ontario, and Janet Harvey is the Manitoba champion out of the Valor Road Curling Club. In
between
Winnipeg, that's our evening draw, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 p.m. Pacific.
It's not easy to sit out that first draw and watch all the other teams get a chance to get the feel of the ice, but both of those teams have experienced players, and we are looking forward to a great game again tonight. Then we guard it.
Yeah, well, even if you're right on top of this one, that's not.
As long as we're in line with it.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's close.
Okay.
It doesn't move a whole lot until it gets over to the center line. Worst thing we could do is overcut, though, eh?
Maybe a touch more.
Well, you're playing top 12 weight, eh?
Yeah, a little more. Yeah.
Top 12, she says. So
let's
right
go
here.
Right here. Yeah. What? Yeah, well, we drew that one there, though, with this ice. Yeah. That's Jones Rock. Yeah. Are you in this game? Are you here?
We're all allowed to have a little sleep sometimes, you know, Vic.
Yeah.
Top 12. Yeah. Line's the most important thing here, so.
As you two pointed out so clearly in the break.
I thought Linda woke you pretty nicely. Yeah. No, Ray?
It will be my turn this week, I'm sure. Got to get used to the teams and the rock colors and who has last rock. It's not easy. We have to get used to everything the first day, just like the players.
Just fine, guys. Top 12, Wolf, you can.
Final stone for Saskatchewan here in six, leading 2-1. Team Canada does have last rock. Marilyn Bodogh.
No, it's.
We'll get a look at draw weight as far as the stopwatch goes. That looks like it's sliding a bit too much. The time's too low. She didn't want it there. She said line was the most important, trying to get them lined up one in front of the other.
On the nose, maybe
it's not that much, but.
You gotta hit it here. Right. Just wondering what turn to come. I think this turn.
I think I'd come into it too. Wouldn't
Let's
you,
just
Linda?
Play for the one, eh? Yeah. We've seen this spot be so tricky from the outside.
12 and a half.
You think 12 and a half?
Hitting this one here. Just catching this one, which you'll push it that way, and you can sit in the 4 foot for a single.
What do you think of that ice?
I think that would have been okay if we would have had the weight.
Yeah, I think the line was okay with a little bit less weight for sure. Had a little bit more, because you hit a piece of it.
Yeah.
Even if you're in line, you know, edge to edge.
Edge to edge. No, she can't dick around with it, no.
She can't afford to hit this on the nose. Well, maybe she could, Linda. She hits it right on the nose.
Looks close, but it's certainly a center line roll would be the safety side.
Yep.
Final stone, Team Canada.
Well, yeah!
Marilyn Bodogh. Facing two.
Hurry! Hurry! Hurry!
Any roll. Nice shot.
Gets the roll to catch the four for her single.
Jesus, I know. Good thing.
A little surprised by the ice. It's a little trickier than they may have expected. One for Team Canada. Evens it up. 2-2. Saskatchewan will have hammer in the seventh.
Well, that side's
that's
all
okay.
Right.
Yeah, that side's okay.
Let's update the game between New Brunswick, Quebec. Fifth end, final stone for Chantelle Osborne, trailing 3-2 to New Brunswick's Heidi Hanlon. Hanlon is lying to Osborne through the port, but then comes and crashes off her own and will roll too far. It's a steal of two for Heidi Hanlon, and she now leads 5-2 over Quebec as they play the sixth here in Vancouver in the 1997 Scott Tournament of Hearts.
This sports break is brought to you by Scotiabank. What to do?
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to the TSN Newsroom. I'm Darren Titian with a sports break. We're going to stay on the ice. Five games in the NHL this afternoon. You've got the Florida Panthers and the Philadelphia Flyers. It's the fifth meeting between these two teams so far this season. Early on, Florida led it by a count of 2-1. Eric Desjardins all over a rebound that ties the game up at two. Then the Panthers in the power play. Lindsay with a bad pass. Brendamore breaks away. He snaps it home. A shorthanded goal. That, in fact, makes it 3-2. They continue to play in this hockey game, and a very good game indeed. Still in the second period, still 3-2. Meanwhile, the Detroit Red Wings and the St. Louis Blues this afternoon. The Wings cling to a 1-0 lead. And that'll do it for now. We'll have another update for you in about an hour's time. We'll see you then.
Where in the world do you want to call? Polynesia or Peterborough? Deutschland or Denver? Wherever you call, AT&T Canada now offers you 25% savings over the local phone company's rates with no restrictions. With the AT&T Canada True Choice Anywhere Savings Plan, we don't tell you when or where to call. There's absolutely no spending minimum, no three-number maximums, no restrictions whatsoever. Just a full 25% savings, no matter what. Sign up now, and we'll also give you 1 month of free long distance to call anywhere in the world, from St. John's to Singapore. Absolutely free. Call 1-800-790-2255 right now for your 25% savings, plus 1 month free to call the world. We've got other choices, too. Just ask us.
Thank you for choosing AT&T Canada.
So call anywhere in the world, but call us first.
The 1997 Scott Tournament of Hearts from Vancouver is brought to you by Cottony Soft Cottonelle Bathroom Tissue.
Hey, hi! And hi to everyone back home in Newfoundland. Newfoundlanders, Laura Phillips are on the ice in this opening draw, leading 2-1 over British Columbia. They're playing six, and we'll keep everyone updated in Newfoundland on what's going on there. As we go to the seventh end of our featured game, Team Canada takes one and six to even it at 2-2. Saskatchewan does have last rock.
Yep.
And Saskatchewan now.
Okay, Jane.
Lying one, and then maybe the shot stone now is that shot just put in there by Jane Hooper-Perot.
Well, Marilyn threw the first rock out in front, and you could see it was off the center line, and so Sandra took the opportunity, went right around, and a good shot by Marcy Gooderite, and you just saw the shot come down where Marilyn Bodogh tried to freeze to the face of the stone behind the long guard, and no such luck.
Right over. Oh, that a girl. Nice.
Saskatchewan with last rock, now line two, one of them buried.
Two great shots by Marcia, getting that one not too deep. The yellow stone that's 4 foot. If it was too deep, they could freeze to it, the Team Canada team, and half shot rock. And then a nice hit and roll by Marcia as well.
Marilyn trying the angle freeze again on the stone, just sitting in the 4 foot at the 12 o'clock position. Half in the four or three quarters in the four. Covered by the guard just off the center line.
Where is it?
You'll see it come into view in just a moment.
4 foot, gotta move.
Gotta move. No, nothing.
Corey Beveridge. No. Saskatchewan has hammer here in seven.
Just holding up on the frost line. Great weight, Corey.
Wonderful weight is right. Just had to curl a bit more.
This internet question brought to you by Ford from Terry Libley in London. How tough is it for Team Canada to compete in the Scot without the provincial playdowns?
Well, I was on a Team Canada team. This was a few years ago, of course, 1986. But I think it depends a little bit on the person, because I was saying that Marilyn, as Team Canada this year, plays with a lot of emotion and plays better when she has the confidence and the feel of the ice. And so for her, I think it's very critical to come with sort of some sort of feeling, some sort of play coming into the championship. Other players can prepare themselves without the benefit of provincial play, so I really think it depends from team to team. We felt we were pretty well prepared right up until I didn't have a very good final.
12 and a half!
Which can happen no matter how many provincial playdowns you play in.
But you had a good round robin.
We had an excellent round robin.
So then it had nothing to do with the preparation, did it?
I don't think so. That one could have a whole thesis done on it, probably.
Good shot again by Joan.
Those yellow stones of Saskatchewan starting to pile up.
On the nose.
Okay.
Kim. Marilyn and the team made a trip to. Whoa.
Speaking of
trip. How much of this one?
Made a trip to Switzerland to play in a couple of Bonds fields there. But and as much as you say those are our preparation, they really aren't.
It's just not the same. It's a great event. It's been a terrific event for many years.
Roll right into this area here. Same weight, you heard Sandra say very clearly. Joan just getting it straight in her mind as she sits in the hack. Out turn hit.
Same weight. Yeah! Whoa! Whoa!
As designed.
Whoa.
Wonderful shot. She is a competitor. She is tough.
Jumped right off the telestrator and onto the ice.
Whoa.
Well, I'm really paying attention now, boy. I even know who has last rock in this end.
Raise our red.
Good sweeping, good control of the weight to get the perfect roll.
I'm up to this
nice
one.
Shot by Saskatchewan. It's one of those where you can't see either rock that well. The two stones on the left of center line.
I see like corner of the first and back.
Not yeah. quite all of the second.
Yeah, okay.
These two teams, Linda Ray, obviously, I think if you're going to pick two teams, might have been the favorites coming in. So you can't make
better?
Too much of the fact that they're playing in the first draw, but
I don't know, do you think the
how
answer?
Important is this game to these teams?
One
winning it,
way.
One losing it.
The other way, we have to cross the face a bit.
12.
I don't know.
Well, okay, the run back is here. Sorry, Linda, just run this back.
12,
this is a
yep.
big shot, trying to catch those stones back there if possible. This is a huge shot in this end.
And to answer you, Vic, it's these kinds of shots you want to have and feel confident about moving into the rest of the week. So the win and loss isn't as important as the performance and feeling like you're in the game
right
the whole
off.
Way.
Right off.
No.
Big 12.
Okay.
Saskatchewan in a tremendous Kay. Position here to really break this Kay. Game wide open.
Let's go here.
Okay.
Unfortunately, when you play that kind of shot,
well, I mean,
the run back
right
on the guard, once you don't make it, you've now
there.
Lost your option
you
of bailing out of this
right
end,
there.
And that was the center line guard. While it was there, you still had a way
okay.
to get out of it
same
without giving up a big
same
end.
Out there too, isn't it?
It's a good call by Sandra. There's two stones, one on the four and one on the eight, but yes, there's going to be doubles someplace on the ice surface, but you can lie four here. You have
so
advantage
much.
Of last rock.
Right there.
So this is
no,
a good call. She'll draw to the open to the far side, in turn draw. She'll be in front of the stone, sitting in the 12 foot at the 8 o'clock position.
Does this look a little hot?
You don't yep. want to miss this, though.
No!
Yep. Split it up, split it up,
no,
split it up!
No, stop touching it!
Well, I know, but you're not through the ring. It's okay.
Don't panic. That's the combination that we've seen for so long. It's a very effective one.
And from one end, you think it's through, but Standard was right. She was trying to get a little mm-hmm. bit of separation between the rocks.
Big shot for this young third for yeah, Team Canada, yeah. Kim Gillard. She's got to come up with a double here and possibly a roll.
Curling too much.
Hit.
Yes.
Sweeping.
We got three.
But this is an interesting spot because Kim's rock is sitting top 12.
Yeah.
And it does afford Marilyn a potential shot
center,
later
yeah.
on.
You just knew when I let that go.
Yeah.
It's going to curl too much.
Just curled too much.
But it was dangerous.
That's why Sandra's having such a long look at this.
Time
it's
out.
Not third shot, it's fourth
time
shot,
out.
But it's in a very
really
bad
like
spot for Sandra.
Oh, no,
and Team
I don't
Canada's,
either.
If she, well, or rather, Saskatchewan's called the first
it.
Of
yeah,
their
she
two timeouts.
She's perfect to be buried. If we hit and roll out there, she's got the hit and roll over there. If we go over there, she's going to run that back.
Yeah.
If she misses it, she's in deep trouble. If she makes it, we've got a double out of the end, right? If we hit and roll over there, that's perfect.
If we hit and roll, even if we hit and roll, because if we hit, even if we hit and roll over there, though, we leave her the hit and roll behind.
Yeah.
But I don't really like leaving that one there. What do you think?
Maybe that one there?
Yeah.
We got three.
Now, Coach yeah. Anita Ford has joined them on the ice.
Well, we can hit and roll.
Even if we
hit
and
roll out,
it's
line.
Not that. She's got to make the perfect hit and roll, though. Got to make
yeah.
it. And at least we're going to have an open shot this way. If we leave that,
there.
Go over here, she's going to.
She makes that, and then we have to make a double to get out of the end.
Whatever you want. It, either one, like, it doesn't really matter.
Okay.
Just can't. Yeah, I just can't overcurl.
Like you said, it in roll to there is perfect.
Okay, we let them tell you exactly what they're going to do. There's the options. Options were to
just normal
to draw over
fine.
Here.
Yeah.
They discussed it, or to hit this and try and roll yeah. over there, and that's what they decided to do. You don't want to jam this back.
Jan Becker to lie four.
Well.
Playing 7 in a 2-2 tie.
Lovely shot, Jan Betker.
One thing they weren't worried about is the option now for Marilyn to get a big roll into that pocket area or to even draw in it if she wants to try that double, first.
Or double anyways.
Well, if I wasn't going to do anything to save anything, that's really risky on your first shot.
There's this, hitting this, rolling over there, trying to sit in here by rolling.
Yeah, play it this way, just the way she did.
That's what she's talking about now.
Do you like the hit and roll?
Kim's talking about this here.
I kind of feel that.
12?
What weight do you think she just threw there?
She wasn't 12, she was 12 and a half probably.
I think so.
No, no.
12.
A pretty long roll for that pin.
12. What you've been throwing.
It's a good roll though, isn't it?
It is. It's very nice. It's a good circle too.
Well, that week in Florida certainly helped, you know, that Teller Strader school.
She just threw about 12 and a half. She got a perfect roll. She got a perfect roll.
Updating you on other scores in this opening draw of the 97 Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Would be an understatement to say that this is a key shot, Linda.
It's a way out, though, that little pile of rocks on the right-hand side. If Marilyn can roll near them, you're very hard to get rid of this rock.
Yes. Yep.
First of the skip stones.
Whoa.
Team Canada's Marilyn Bodogh.
Yes.
Whoa.
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 Yes.
Whoa.
There it is. Look at this roll right into the pocket. Oh, that's the way to do it.
A great shot.
And once again, how much and how important is Kim Gillard and her call?
She was right. She was calling the line perfectly. And those long rolls are not easy. They talked about how lively the house is.
Whoa.
Nice shot.
It was a little on and off, which is a good sign.
I knew as soon as she said, I can feel this. Way to go.
But perfect roll, though. She can't bounce it out.
We got lots of time.
What happens if I hit that top one? Probably nothing good.
This is just going to jam right on there and just roll there.
That's what she's talking about. What happens if I hit that
one?
Even
this?
Yeah, I don't mind that.
That's pretty good if I do that. Get some separation there as long as I'm shot rock, okay?
Like just back 12 weight, I think.
Yeah. That's about there to draw there. And if I touch that top one and roll into here, that's not bad.
Yeah.
Hitting that one just 12 foot, trying to push that back. Push that back.
Okay, let's do it.
And then you heard her say, it's not too bad either if I come down and just, if I happen to tick
back
this.
Back line weight.
And just sit in front there. But a great roll is really.
Shit.
No, it's okay.
Taking the end away from Saskatchewan.
We're kind of playing like a back line, just to corner freeze it and move some stuff around over there.
Yeah. Okay. There you are.
She knows that this just may have turned around on her, and she's showing her frustration by it. But Sandra has to put that away right now, doesn't she?
And I'm sure she will. She's a very experienced player. I don't think that's a problem. Once she's in the hack, I'm sure she'll be thinking about the shot only. But what a great rule, because you saw them talk about possibly running back the yellow stone that's in front of the other ones, but they don't even think that will work as far as angles. So they want to try and jiggle things around and see if they can still get something out of this end.
But really, it not only did it roll in there, it froze to the face of the back one. So.
No!
Whoa, I think. That's good.
That's a lovely shot. Marilyn's going to have to be so careful now.
Yeah, no more. Just draw to it. Hey?
Just a draw and a very, let's have a very careful one. Anywhere in here like this, try and be shot rock.
That's
wait,
good.
Where she put her brush?
Right here.
What's the worst I can do here?
Well, where was she? Because she had backline.
Oh, yeah.
Just
she cleared
it.
Okay, yeah, let's go there.
Very interesting end. Well executed end by Saskatchewan, and just a great roll. Great shot
by
Marilyn Bodogh that gave her the chance to get out. If she puts a rock in a good position here, she can hold this in to a single point. And boy, will she be pleased with that.
We can come off our own.
Jan gave Sandra a little tap on the head with the end of her brush there.
Yep.
Final stone for Team Canada and Marilyn Bodogh. Saskatchewan does have hammer.
No line.
Just a draw.
They're saying that it's a little bit heavy. Jane does time these, of course, back line to hog, first hog line.
Whoa, Carl, come on, come on, come on, come on.
No, I don't like it.
Yeah, nose hit.
Hair too much?
Yeah, nose hit is right.
Too much weight?
Well, actually, I think you gotta come into the nose a bit because you gotta make sure you move this one enough.
Have to throw normal weight, eh?
Hitting this one
I
here.
I might lose this one.
Actually.
But this has to go into that, right?
It will just
even hitting gotta make sure we have enough to
into
get that,
that
one,
one which will remove
even
that one.
The worst thing would be only to get, because even if we hit this and roll it flop over here, we're still gonna get two, hey?
Yeah.
But you, yeah. You can get the big end by going the other way.
Well, let's play nose hit. This has to go. This has to go at least to here with normal weight.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
If we cut the face a bit, we're probably coming into that a little bit.
Hit that one.
Nose hit, eh?
Just hit this one here, which will move that one there.
That's good.
Normal weight?
Three or four.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
She could get four here.
As this end has
normal.
Seesawed back and forth, Marilyn Bodogh with her great hit and roll to cut it down when she was facing four. And now just maybe a little heavy, not enough curl, and gives a chance for four right back.
We probably get two.
We heard her explanation. Even
maybe.
If it comes across the face, she might get two.
That,
but this is
the back one has to run into the other one.
There's Marilyn counting them up right now.
Just a little heavy she was on her shot.
Is that too much ice?
No, that looks good. That looks great. Okay, so pretty.
Final stone.
Whoa.
Sandra Schmirler.
Whoa.
Big, big weight.
Whoa.
She thought the big end had disappeared.
Yeah.
Yes.
Does she have a chance to get it right back here?
Okay, whoa.
Look at them go. Four. Put it on the board. Frustrated two stones ago, and now she makes the shot to score four and break it open here in the seventh.
Fast relief from the pain of heartburn is why Maalox is the most trusted choice of pharmacists in Canada.
Deli shaved Black Forest ham, oven roasted turkey and chicken. Assorted sub!
Popular downtown deli or the Winklers on Maple Street. Introducing the new and improved taste of maple leaf sandwich meats that will turn your home into a deli. Deli-shaved Black Forest ham, oven-roasted turkey and chicken. Sub Express with ham bologna and summer sausage.
You forgot the mustard on table 7.
And you forgot your check.
New maple leaf sandwich meats. Taste that's a cut above.
This was a commercial for Bounty Jumbo, it would end right here. But it's a commercial for Scott Towels Jumbo, which soaks up big spills as well as Bounty Jumbo. Yet Scott Towels Jumbo is 22% longer. Scott Towels, strong, absorbent, and lots on a roll.
At first glance, this CV joint looks like most other CV joints, except for one important feature. Only UAP Napa CV joints meet the top quality standards of UAP Napa. UAP Napa, the right brand for the job. Available at AutoPro and UAP Napa member installers.
The pain of arthritis and joint stiffness can get the better of many people. So today, there's coated extra strength aspirin with the power to relieve your worst pain right where it hurts. Aspirin, it really knows your pain.
My nose is stubbed up, dry, and irritated too. Otrivin. New Otrivin with moisturizers.
The key shot of the seventh brought to you by Labatt.
And it looked like the key shot might be Marilyn Bodogh's first shot when she made a wonderful hit and roll, but she makes a mistake on her second one, leaves her two red stones accessible for Sandra Schmirler, and there they go. What a terrific shot.
Well, the interesting thing, you really have to give Sandra a lot of credit, and actually her first shot was a very, very astute and good call. She said, you know, I can't get it out of there. I can't run anything back. Let me put her, let's go down with back 12-foot weight, try and move things around. And what you're saying, in essence, that maybe she'll make a mistake. Well, she did make that mistake, and the result of the mistake was a four-ender. So a good call by Sandra, and obviously a great execution in the last one.
And as we begin the eighth, Team Canada, Marilyn Bodogh has hammered, trailing 6-2. And the last word Sandra said to her team was, no three balls.
Well, you know that they can get up guards, and that means that they have a chance of getting two, but you certainly, when you take your four, if you get back a two, it's not bad, but a three is not great. So they know they're calm. They know what they want to do.
I think so.
Just here?
I don't like...
But really was a textbook, Ann, just to go back
See,
to that end again.
See, if we shoot here, then that corner's hard to peel.
Okay,
so
I'll go, John.
Let's go through. Intern.
She's going to throw it through. Good call. No more rocks in play. I don't want any more rocks in play. Is what she's saying. She knows she's going to peel with the next one. Going back to that end, it was, you know, because Saskatchewan really executed a wonderful end. Kim Gillard,
really
you know, had a chance to run a few rocks back and didn't make those shots.
It, but
then Saskatchewan just executed perfectly.
I don't think
and it's a good illustration of how one big shot can really turn an end around with Marilyn making an absolutely great hit
corner?
And roll.
Yeah.
But... a little mistake on her last one, just a little too much weight. She had perfect line, just a little too much weight. She sits in front of it. There's no way that Santa's going to be able to get more than one.
As a skip, those are the ones you hate to miss, those second ones, because when you're playing the tough shot,
tighter.
You're so focused,
right,
and that's
here.
Often why you make them so well, because you're concentrating so well. That Marilyn just drove out too hard from the hack, and maybe the focus was lost for a moment, and maybe something
line,
a little short on. Also would have worked for her, but being deep was the last thing she could
exactly.
be.
Great shot, Jane.
That is the dangers of this ice, though. It's so hard. It's so slick, you know. We said that early in the game.
Okay, John.
Sandra now will start the peeling process. Get rid of the front stones. It's the front stones in this game that will cost you as they inevitably will end up resulting some offense for your opposition.
Good.
A couple of choices for Marilyn. She could play another corner guard. She could freeze to the house in the ring. She could go behind the corner she already has up. There's the call. One more corner guard. This second corner guard is actually an attempt to try and get three. But one corner guard can give you the extra point, Linda.
You can get around it, and if the opponent misses or hits the guard, then you can draw the second one in.
Nice.
But if you can get around two guards, in the process of them having to get rid of them, you can get the third point into the house.
Okay, it's okay now. Yep, yep, even. Don't set them up. Okay, looks good, looks good.
And you have to be careful with placing guards. Marilyn made a good comment. You have to watch where the guards are positioned so you don't leave your opponent a double peel. But they're very careful where they sweep that one.
Oh, no! No,
Joan McCusker.
Get over there.
Had a girl.
Good shot.
An anxious moment. Now the freeze, Linda, what do you think? Or the corner. Looks like she's gonna play the corner guard to come around. Just taking over the edge of the center line.
Line's good.
8 foot.
Oh, it's got a lot of curling to do.
Yep.
See?
Yep. Yep.
Trying to sweep it now to take it further, get more curl out of the ice by having it travel the distance and bending further.
Come on.
And playing the little tip.
Shot.
How much of it?
Yep.
Okay. We just don't want to be doing that, eh? We'll play it tight. If you grab that guard, that's fine. Want to throw like a bumper?
No, I like to throw normal.
Well, then we've got to play it pretty tight because we can't take there. You might just come off the top of that.
Well, whatever you want, then.
I don't mind grabbing the guard.
Okay, well.
Okay, throw normal then.
Grabbing the guard.
Well, that'll move that far, won't it? For a normal weight.
Do you want to come look at this?
No.
Okay, throw normal. If you get the guard, fine.
Well, you heard Sanders earlier comment, but we're not going to give up three here, so if you hit the guard, it's okay.
Yep.
We'll give you a deuce, but we're not giving you three.
Yes! Quack! Hurry!
Whoa.
Good.
Well, it's a great shot, but it does leave a couple of rocks for Marilyn to play with now.
Run it a bit.
Jem didn't really want to sit right there.
Mine's good, yep.
Yep.
Where
mine.
Is it?
Room? Room?
Mine's good?
No.
Looks like lots. Yep. It's over curling.
Yep.
Yeah, it's really frosty.
Well, we're one and two.
Good guard. You sit right in there. Like top 12 is okay.
Huh? Can you see any of that?
Yeah, yep.
About there?
Yeah. Touch a smidge more.
You want to play the pick if you get the guard?
No, we can play the guard ourselves.
Oh, I see what you're saying here.
Yeah, I like that. Why that point on? See, last
looked
shot.
At hitting it.
What do you like?
And if they didn't get it, they'd get that one off.
That might be the only way we get into trouble, though.
Sandra, she's
well, right
trouble.
Now.
So then they the other girls in the room were saying, let's play the guard, play our own stone
for
right
them?
There.
Is there a double for them? That's guard.
Guard, then, I guess.
Get it, Jan.
Guard, then, I guess.
That's guard.
What are we guarding? This one?
Yeah.
I like, if we're going to do that, might as well come right in here, then.
Okay.
You may be nestled in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Well.
I like Sanders' comment.
I don't think so. I don't think we can play
time
anything.
Out.
When I'm up four, I don't like playing guards on anything.
Time out.
Okay, that's the second
you.
Time out now.
Did they
though,
get
they
it?
Use theirs up.
Time out.
If we come right in there and sit right on top, and then they punch it back to back eight, then what do we do?
See, if they've got the spin.
Pretty tough double. How are they going to hit the crotch for the double?
How are they? Well, they can see it all, can't they?
Oh, you know,
they don't have to move it. They don't have to move it very far, right?
I'm just worried, like, if we play here, and then they play with, like, back.
Well, then let's just play the pick on this. And get the guard, then we get the guard.
Sandra's first.
And she's going to draw right here.
In there even better, though.
What are you thinking?
Sandra's first comment was to kind of go in,
right here.
Go in here like this. Sort of angle on that one. Should be a good
you
shot.
You want to play.
Well, what happens if we play that, she makes the double, right? Then.
And that one's kind of precarious.
Well, then we just have to hit and make sure we don't jam it, right? See, we can pick this.
Yeah.
And if we get the guard, Joan doesn't like that.
It's the guard they're talking about.
Well, I know, but if we guard here.
Well, I don't want to play in front of the rings. If we're going to guard, I like playing
there's nothing top. Wrong with sit corner freezing that.
Okay, well, let's play right here then.
Let's play here.
Okay.
If you corner freeze, fine.
If your corner freeze,
okay. The corner freeze is really the best, right there.
If the two yellow stones weren't accessible by a double takeout, I think you'd be seeing them play the guard off or go for the red one. But they're just saying that.
John, want to be right in here.
At this point, the yellow ones are in a position where they can both be removed on one shot, and that's why they've determined they're going to play in front of it. But you heard all the what ifs that you have to go through when you're about to call a shot. What if we do this? What will the opponent do? This has to be very well placed by Jan.
How's the way?
Line's good.
Jan Becker, yeah. As we play in the eighth, Saskatchewan leading 6-2.
What's that mean?
Team Canada.
And we should
with
see a
last rock.
Sorry, Beck, we should
this?
See a rock clock about 14 to 14 and a half. So it looks pretty close.
Yep. Yes. Hey! Hey! Okay, that's good, Jan.
Perfect weight.
Good shot. Sorry, that's good.
Even if you touch it back to back four, that's great.
Same weight.
It does give Marilyn a chance, though, to get some stones in here. Back down here. She heard her say, just sit in this area here. And even if you touch it back a little bit, that's fine. And the key here is being down four, and you've got some rocks in play, and you've got a chance to really get yourself in there and maybe sneak three out of this.
Yes, line. Yep, line. Line's tight.
You have to hope for a mistake by your opposition, but with rocks in play, that percentage of mistake is higher. So,
Kim Gillard.
I might have been tempted to peel off the guard, to be honest with you.
Okay.
It's curled so much, eh?
Flop right there.
Yeah. Well, nose isn't so bad, but this is
best. Yeah, I like a little bit of a flop. Would be nice.
Yeah. Right into here. Great.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can throw the out turn here too, you know, because we got a lot to clunk over if we happen to.
Well, we definitely, we don't want to hit it too thin though. Well, if we hit it too thin, this hits here and goes up there. Yeah. I don't think we want to hit it thin. I think we want to. Oh, do you?
No.
Well, then for sure we're going to hit this one if we get the roll. Aren't we?
That's an out turn? No. How are we going to hit that one? We're up here.
Even if we nose it, it's okay.
Yeah. Oh, well, you play the intern then if you want. We can come across the face.
Yeah, no, this is good.
This is the out turn that Jan's talking about.
Okay, too.
Hitting this here, they want to just hit this rock here and try and roll right into this area here. What Sandra
even
was.
If you hit and roll over there is good.
Talking about, well, and then what she's seeing there is even if you hit this and roll over here.
This is the hit in the second end. Remember? Straight as
can. Yeah, yeah. Well, and your peels didn't go anywhere.
Look. They need this one to stay somewhere because they're talking about the fact that the other two yellows are accessible by double for Marilyn. So she does want to stay, but you heard her say just about anywhere, nose or either little roll would be fine for this shot.
We got lots of time for the end of this game, eh?
They've used both their timeouts, remember?
We don't want to hit this too thin, that's for sure.
First skip stone, and this is Sandra Schmirler. Team Canada has hammer.
Geez, that went straight.
Yeah, well, that's what we were saying, remember? That's
that one of mine.
Yeah, that's what we were thinking.
Holy smokes. Yeah. Something just went like the other way, but.
What?
If I played here, she can still pop it out this way. You know? Like, I've got a.
And that's through there.
Right there.
Yeah.
She can still squeeze it out.
Well.
But. Right there, it's good.
Shot.
24?
Yeah.
This is a tough draw because if it's not positioned very well onto the yellow stone, it can be removed. The
And that's got to be tough, too. She knows she has to get them in position. And it's not just position. It's got to be perfect position to build on.
And we saw Kim's come down and just rub off a stone, or it might have been perfect. So it's a very, very delicate shot.
And you're right. Kim Gillard had the chance there to really get one in there and maybe maybe get this end set up. But it just didn't happen.
Yes, for line.
It's a tough shot Marilyn has to play, but she has no alternative, of course.
First stone for the defending champion, the Team Canada skip, Marilyn Bodogh.
Push on it. Come on, hard. Hurry up. Okay, great sweeping.
You did hear them talk about the time being 24 from hog to tee or 14 between the hog lines, and that is a little slower than we did see earlier.
No, Sandra, even if you're short of the rings, it's fine.
Make her draw the four.
Yeah.
Gave Marcy there, she cut too far. Maybe the out turn's easier. We don't have to go out as far.
Losing weight, too.
Yeah, they pounded it.
Marilyn Bodogh curling and playing with her hair. And here we go. Almost like that little nervous twitch.
Just top 12. Just blocking her draw.
I was gonna say, it's that short is okay too.
Yeah, that doesn't block her draw though. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay. All right.
But it makes her go farther out.
Well, not a super stupid there, because right now she doesn't.
She's just got to draw the four.
That's right. So let's leave it short. And
yeah. Okay. So this is a little more ice. Do you think it's the same?
Yeah, the same way. Yeah.
Yeah. Nice trip.
Top
Jones.
8, top 12, guys.
It's top
Line's
12.
Great. Line's great.
Hurry!
Yeah, as far as it'll go.
Hurry!
As far as it'll go. Okay, that's fine.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
That's fine. Okay.
Well, you heard them say the purpose of that rock was to force Marilyn wider with her shot, and as long as it was on center line, it did the job.
Yeah, it's all she could do is...
That forces her out a little farther in.
Yeah.
I didn't want to be heavy.
No, the worst thing you could do is come down and be heavy on that shot. So as you mentioned, Lynn, it's a perfect spot. You just come to top 12, it's fine too. It just doesn't matter.
And with this final stone, Marilyn Bodogh is going to need full four. Just trying to get one back here. Full four. Heavier than that. Right now, she could give up a steal of three if it goes too far. Steal a one, steal a two, possibly three.
It's three, Vic.
I think it's three. I'm so different from that side.
Yeah, three yellow.
Three yellow. Steal of three for Saskatchewan.
Okay, way to go, you guys.
As Marilyn Bodogh, the defending champion, has a look at the scoreboard.
Marilyn, what do you want to do?
Shake it. No, I'll play one more.
No, she wants to play one more. She's not happy with the way she's playing. So they'll play one more. And she'll trail 9-2. Saskatchewan in control in this battle of world champions.
Okay. Way to go, you guys. Good.
Hello? Are you in there? Oh, ever wonder how some mechanics can quote you a package price on brakes without even seeing your car? Well, at Midas, the technicians aren't psychic. They always do a free written inspection first. And the price they quote is the price you pay. It's guaranteed. Just like the word. Midas, the way it should be. I see millions of people driving to Midas.
You're all stars. Performing all-star feats. They're the reason we make the new 98 Windstar with the most powerful engine in its class, plus over 40 standard safety features. In fact, Windstar is the only minivan to earn 5 stars, the highest rating in U.S. government front-end crash tests. A pretty spectacular feat in itself. The new 98 Ford Windstar, created for the most important people in the world.
At Maple Leaf, when we reduce the fat in our new lean and light wieners and bologna, we tested the taste with families just like yours. We found we could reduce the fat by 60%, and lean and light would still have that mouth-watering Maple Leaf taste. Any less fat? Well, then, we'd appeal to only some members of the family. The uncompromised great taste of new Maple Leaf lean and light. Taste that's a cut above.
Maybe you think only those jet set types need a Nokia cellular phone.
Hi, it's me, flight's delayed.
Well now, Nokia's making cellular phones so easy.
Lately. Can I skip my bath?
They're practically child's play.
Attention, flight 11 is delayed.
Can I call you back?
With Nokia's big, easy-to-read screens, last number redial, and sleek designs.
No, don't hold dinner. I'm eating my body weight in hot dogs. No, wait up. You gotta tuck me in.
So get set to join the jet set. Nokia, Europe's leading cellular phone, also made in America, connecting people.
Time now for our CIBC Trust Brain Teaser. Kim Gillard, Corey Beveridge off of Team Canada are the only two curlers to accomplish this feat. What is it? Well, unfortunately, it's the agony of defeat as they lose 9-2 in their opener, but it's something else.
They're both world junior champions and world champions at both levels, are they not? They're both world champions, juniors and
junior
world,
and women's.
Yeah. Yeah.
Far too easy to start this Scott tournament.
We appreciate that.
As we get you caught up, you see New Brunswick Heidi Hanlon picks up 1-8 and leads Chantel Osborne of Quebec 6-3, playing 9. Blank in 8 in a wide open game. Alberta leading 3-2. It's Kathy Borst, Rebecca Jean McPhee from Charlottetown, and 3-2, British Columbia ahead of Newfoundland. And just to bring everyone up to date, when we left you during the for the commercial, Marilyn Bodogh indicated that she wanted to play again, but the team and her discussed it. Instead, they have shaken hands, and it is a Saskatchewan win in 8, 9-2 in this opening draw of the Scott Tournament of Hearts. So we turn our attention to this game. Newfoundland, represented by Laura Phillips and her team from the St. John's Curling Club, against British Columbia and Kelley Owen from the Richmond Winter Club.
This has been a very interesting game. Laura Phillips, of course, with all kinds of experience. And Kelley Owen has had a tremendous year, Linda, from BC. She has an Olympic birth spot in Brandon, so she's had a terrific year. It's a good young team.
Nice ways.
In the eighth end, for example, it looked like Laura Phillips was going to get the deuce that she was trying to get, and Kelley made a tremendous double to get herself out of that situation, and Laura ended up blanking the end to maintain the hammer, playing the ninth. And in the ninth, it looks a little bit like Linda, Laura is kind of trying to get through the end and blank it and try and get her deuce in 10. The rock, the play has been all in the ring. This would be no attempt by Laura to try and get the deuce in this end.
And with BC, of course, having a point lead, they did bring that first rock purposefully into the house and hope that Newfoundland would go after it, which they did, and that's why we're seeing an exchange of takeouts. But it potentially sets up that fascinating situation in the 10th end. If it is a blank, then it's the team up 1 point, but without that last rock advantage. And we love to talk about those.
That's right. That's the perennial discussion. What would you rather be? What would you rather be? One down with or one up without?
That last rock still is pretty tempting.
Yeah, I feel the same way. Especially with the feet guards.
Well, the difference being nowadays, too, that the one-up situation, we often say that you no longer are playing to keep it clean, that you might have to think about being aggressive. So it's added all sorts of new dimensions to the game. Yeah.
And Sandra Schmirler meeting the media.
Sandra, could you
after her
talk a little bit about the competition here this
opening
week.
It's 9-2 win over the defending champions Team Canada.
Well, it definitely is the toughest Scott that we've been in when you look at the repeat winners and and especially the amount of teams that have experience. It's the best field and I've been in six.
Radio reporter Brian Dance and Sandra confirming what we all believe. This is indeed the most experienced, toughest field who ever assembled for a Scott Tournament of Hearts.
It was a nice victory for Sandra. You know, as we mentioned earlier, she had to win her way back here, and she did so, and she's really pleased to be here. In fairness to Marilyn Bodogh, Marilyn made a lot of good shots. She made a little slip in the end, and she gave up the four, but she made a great shot on that end to try and get herself out of the position. And I'm sure they'll go back to the hotel and regroup. But Kim Glard just didn't seem as sharp as she normally, you know, has been, or we've seen her being in the past. And that's all it takes. Linda has one little, one little chink in the armor. And
but as well for especially Team Canada, they weren't getting the guards up, and that really is their game, trying to get the come arounds and make the quiet shots, and that just wasn't happening. And I think the adjustment to the ice will happen for them.
Playing third stones here in the ninth, British Columbia leading Newfoundland 3-2. This is Marla Geiger. The last time we saw this British Columbia team was 2 years ago, and it was Marla Geiger skipping the team at that point. Linda, Kelley, Owen playing third. They have switched since then. What was the reason?
They were struggling all along deciding. Both of them are fine skips and had played very well, but it's again what we talked about earlier, the chemistry, the combination of who will skip and who will play third and how that will work in this situation. And last year even they struggled back and forth, but this year Kelley took the reins and ran with them and has been just a tremendous player for this team.
Kathy Cunningham, a very, very one of the strongest thirds here. She's shown that to us over the years. Laura's asked for a corner guard here. And so it'll be interesting to see what Kelley Owen does, whether she forces Laura to try and take the single, or is she, and in doing so, taking a little bit of a chance he may give up a deuce. But this next call will be very interesting if this rock, in fact, stops in front, and it doesn't look like it's going to. Oh yeah, it does. The peel.
This Ford internet question from Mark Shannon in Winnipeg. Will ice conditions have an effect on which teams will succeed this week?
Yeah, I really think it will. And we talked about that in our opening comments, Vic, that, the ice, some people prefer straighter ice than others in some teams. This ice is moving big time. It curls all the way down. It's just not a late finish. And it's a good question. I think, yeah, the answer to it is yes, it will.
Good question from another Winnipegger.
Absolutely. I've seen it over the years in many cases. You go back to, we'll see it at the Briar. Some teams prefer more of a hitting style of game. And if the ice is straighter, that kind of is to their advantage. If you get lots of movement, the teams that like the come around game, the Janet Harvey, and Marilyn Bodogh likes that kind of a game, as Linda mentioned. It didn't work too well for her. And you go back to that game, it was, that show was a great example of how front ends can make a big difference. In that fateful seventh end, Marcia Goodright made one great come around and a couple of good shots that started that off. That's all it takes. Those front end shots are so important. Joan McCusker followed up with a couple of great shots, and next thing you know, you're lying three or four.
Newfoundland and British Columbia. Opening draw of this Scott Tournament of Hearts. Newfoundland trailing by one, has last rock as we get ready for skip stones. And this is the 31-year-old skip for this BC team from the Richmond Winter Club, Kelley Owen. '90, '90, '92, '95 when she played third, and now 1997.
In 1992, she also played third, that time for Lisa Walker. So two times as third and twice as a skip. And a very fine player at both positions.
And a fine peel. Galore will go into the rings now and hope maybe that Kelley hits and rolls out. It's a good combination. We've seen it over the years. Laura Phillips and Kathy Cunningham.
Well, this Newfoundland team has been perennial within the province. They've won four straight Newfoundland championships. Laura Phillips, Kathy Cunningham, Kathy Kerr, and Heather Martin. And of course, the curling tradition continues within the Phillips family. We saw Laura's dad. He skipped the Newfoundland team at the CIBC Seniors at the Thornhill Country Club in Toronto. Well, I guess in Thornhill, part of Greater Metropolitan Toronto.
Yes, you better clear that up, otherwise you'll never go back to Thornhill.
Right.
Well, you talk about experience, you know, the heart that's emblematic of a trip to the Scott Tournament of Hearts, and so dearly wanted by everyone that curls in this country, the Purple Heart for the Briar and the Red Heart for the Scott. This team, talk about hearts, they have 24 of them, Linda, so there's a lot of experience in this team. They want to just hang on here.
The other thing you have to like about Newfoundland is they've won those last four hearts together. So mm-hmm. they've played together, stayed together, even though they haven't been totally successful at the Scott Tournament of Hearts in the past. And building a team is some of the hardest things that you can do as a player.
Our statistician Jerry Campbell points out that when these two teams played last in round robin was 95, when Marla Geiger was skipping. British Columbia beat Laura Phillips 8-6, and that was in the 11th round of that year.
This was actually turned out to be a very good shot by Laura, because it just hung on the back 12 foot. So for Kelley to hit and stick, she has to hit it right on the nose. If she rolls out, it allows Newfoundland to blank the end and accomplish what she set out to do, or looked like she set out to do, which was maintain last rock, coming home one down.
Right on the nose.
But the other thing it does, even though Kelley did hit and stay, there is not a long distance for Laura to roll now to get the blank. That's the other nice thing about being near the back of the house.
Newfoundland looking to hit this and blank the end, roll out of the rings, maintaining the hammer, the last rock, playing the 10th, one down, coming home with last rock.
Laura, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say probably what you were going to say is that Laura has tremendous powers of concentration as well. You can see she cleans the rock, stands up, sets herself, visualizes, and now she's set.
I wasn't going to say that at all.
But it was something good, so you could take credit for thinking
it. Yeah, screw it up.
Well, I thought you were thinking that, Nick. We have been together for 12 years, so.
Final stone looking for the blank, Newfoundland. Comes up enough.
What were you going to say then?
Nothing quite as good. So they'll blank 9, and Newfoundland will have the hammer when we play 10, trailing by 1 as we quickly go to sheet D. And the 9th end, New Brunswick and Quebec. And it is 6-3. New Brunswick leading Quebec, Chantal Osborne. And this is her final stone. As this is a draw for 2, she's counting 1, sitting edge of the 12 foot at around the 7 o'clock position.
They've worked that right out of her hand.
Have they ever? Did they get it there? No. What a big point.
Missed opportunity as she had a chance to score 2 to pull within 1. Instead, New Brunswick and Heidi Hanlon will lead by 2 and have hammer as we continue with our coverage, the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Who do you love? Let me understand this. If I'm in the middle of shooting and you yell car, then the goal doesn't count.
That's the rule.
But I already took the shot.
Doesn't matter.
But I already took the shot.
That's the rule. I didn't make it up.
So what do you think, in the NHL they yell car? Real goalies don't yell car.
What? I can't believe you finished them.
I'm sorry, buddy. That's the rules. I didn't make them up.
Kellogg's Frosted Flake cereal for kids of all ages. They're great.
Dad, did you have any friends when you were a kid?
Hello? Hello? Are you in there?
Oh, ever wonder how some mechanics can quote you a package price on brakes without even seeing your car? Well, at Midas, the technicians aren't psychic. They always do a free written inspection first. And the price they quote is the price you pay. It's guaranteed. Just like the word. Midas, the way it should be. I see millions of people driving to Midas.
Purex has gone to great lengths to give you a longer-lasting bathroom tissue. Purex Double Roll. With twice as many pillowy soft sheets on every roll, it takes forever to run out. Purex Double Roll. Pillowy softness that lasts twice as long.
I don't like this call.
And welcome back to our coverage of this opening draw of the Scott Tournament of Hearts. Our featured game is over. Saskatchewan winner over Team Canada 9-2. We're in the 10th end. British Columbia leading 3-2 over Newfoundland. And Laura Phillips has last rock. First stone of BC into the ring, sitting on the button, and then Newfoundland with their first stone from Heather Martin played up to it.
Yeah, I don't like the call. I'd be very frank about it. I would have played the corner guard into the free guard zone area, leaving the rock in the forefoot. Now, you know, you can get a jam and possibly set up 2 points by doing this, but I think that the free guard zone rule is set there for a reason and let's utilize it. And on quick, keen ice like this, the perfect freeze is very difficult, and getting the rocks out is not that difficult. There's your jam. Now you may, you know, set up your deuce, but I prefer the corner guard shot.
Do you agree, Linda?
I do, but what was interesting with that last call is BC actually tried to jam it, and they tried to sit right in front of it because they didn't think the pick was that easy. So Kelley was actually thinking ahead and possibly setting up a chance to avoid getting into trouble by playing it straight back and then juggling some rocks around. But so that's the problem when you don't play the guard. There are options for the other team to blast them out of the house.
And as Laura Phillips and Kathy Cunningham talk about it, let me ask you something though. You're the opposition has put one on the right on the button. You throw up the corner. The fear is that they put up the perfect guard and now you go on the, you have to bail, continually bail to get that stone off.
Yeah, you've got 7 stones to do it with. A lot of things, if they slip into the rings, you might get the double, you get the, just a hit and a roll. I mean, I like the corner guard call much better, and you'll see the corner guard call much more often than that freeze in that situation. Laura played the entire night to blanket. I was surprised when she played the rock in front of it. It was a good shot by BC getting it into the button area, into the forfeit area, but.
The Newfoundland lead is Heather Martin.
So now what's difficult for Newfoundland is they're trying to come in and sit near the face of the BC rock so they don't set up a double. It's very precise, trying to get it so their rocks are in better position and cannot be removed.
Too strong. Double's there. Hit it on the nose, you'll get them both.
Sherry Fraser. Native of Lethbridge, Alberta. Lethbridge, one of the many cities that has hosted a Scott Tournament of Hearts.
'87.
Laura's guarding the shot rock now. A couple of options, of course. She could freeze to the back yellow one. And the outturn guard, it looks like.
One better than the other here, Linda, in terms of guarding or freezing to the back?
This you certainly have to put into perfect position again. It puts a lot of pressure on the player to get it in front properly. But the reason they try this is so that they don't have to worry about putting the rocks in the rings perfectly separated time after time.
Kathy Kerr.
Curled a little too much, but she did leave, she protected the proper side of it because there is a yellow stone on the other side of the rings. But I think that we haven't been on the sheet, and that outturn looked like it ran pretty straight, Linda, so that may be a little more difficult shot to get to than it originally looked like. Kelly's moved out. You can see she's moved out to get a look at the angle, see exactly how much she can see. She walked out to take a look at this. There was some comment about peeling that. Trouble with trying to hit this one is that you can drive it back onto that. And it runs pretty straight down in this area, so. Kelly's now talking about drawing in. Just tapping this back. Just sitting in this area here.
So do you like this call, Ray? Come around with the intern side?
Just coming with the intern, yeah. The movement must be. No, I don't know. I mean, I would, I might be tempted to run the guard off.
I think if I was playing in at all, I might try it with the other side, only because no matter what you do with this, they have lots of chances to tap theirs up on the other side. I would be tempted to run the guard and see what they did.
Well by, in fact.
The bad thing, Laura makes a shot here and just taps that rock back a little bit. Mind you, she has to score two. And if she taps it back, she won't be shot a second shot rock. She could make a little bit of move on the back yellow one, I think. Looks like the intern comes quite a bit. This is what I'm talking about here, is what she's looking at, coming down and just sitting on top of this one here. You gotta be careful though, because your opposition will then follow you down. Could be shot. That's the other discussion you can see. Just maybe to come down and just tap it and roll over, Kathy was saying.
Could make a play on your own,
yeah,
and tap it onto the yellow one at the back and roll away a little bit even.
What Linda was saying is talking about maybe you can make a play on that one and tap it back into this area here. If you move it a few inches, it could be a shot. Or lie two, I should say, I guess. She's making a play on the back one. The intern looks like it comes a lot more than the outturn.
It's a lot of rocks in play for this early in the end. We're only on second stones, and we've already got a big collection in the house.
Kathy Kerr. In this 10th, with British Columbia leading 3-2, Newfoundland does have hammer. An update for you from Sheet C, the game between Prince Edward Island and Alberta. 3-2, Alberta. Kathy Borst leading Rebecca Jean McPhee, her final stone for the skip from the Otwell Curling Club. And now it came down to a measurement of those two stones around the edge of the 12, and she was just shot stone. So Alberta and Kathy Borst pick up the win 4-2 over Prince Edward Island in this opening draw of the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Now Newfoundland sitting two, and it's not a great situation for BC, even though they can try and get around the centerline rocks and get something in there. They can't make a play on this and get a roll. They'd have to play it very quietly. So instead, they're going to play it with big weight.
Trying the double. Pick it out of there.
Marla Geiger and the first stone for the BC third here in 10. Got it by, they do. Come across, get them both, no.
Laura put this back, try and get it buried a little bit more.
This will give us an indication of how much it will move, because we've only seen shots either the guard where they didn't take very much ice, or of course the big weight hit. See what the come around does.
Kathy Cunningham. Her seventh appearance at a national championship. Newfoundland still looking to win their first Canadian women's title. On the front one.
Moved the whole way. Trying to protect theirs at the back now by sweeping that one over.
Well, we don't have the advantage of the microphones, but it looked like she got that started right away, or really went right away anyway, one way or the other. Chipped the guard over and covered half of it. Kelley looking to see, you know, how much of this stone she can see. It's covered partially by that one there. So she's gone to the tap back on her own stone, trying to drive it back into this area here.
Marla Geiger, another of the former world junior champions who's made a successful transition to women's play. This opened the door for a possible two for Newfoundland here in 10.
Well, she's had the end set up for two, Vic, right after I told her she played the wrong shot. I would have played the corner guard, which I would have done. It's worked out that the jam that she got early in the end, and she's been able to maneuver around. And I think if Kathy Cunningham can put a good stone in here now, I think she can really put BC in jeopardy.
But as we say, it takes two to tango, and Kelley Owen made a switch herself to offensive play, which has allowed these rocks to accumulate and Newfoundland to have these opportunities.
You have to be able to adjust your game, but you know, you go, let's go back to Laura Phillips and the first stone. She she plays the freeze. Has she maintained then that thought? Has she played always that way through this end?
She's played to get her two, and yeah. The freeze was the option. We said that maybe the corner guard was better in this situation, but certainly the freeze was a way to generate points, and that's what she's still trying to do.
So the shot she's looking at coming down here, sitting right in this area here. Second shot behind this guard here. Don't want to be deep, or you allow your opposition to follow you down.
She again hasn't taken a lot of ice.
No, it's that would indicate that Kathy got that first one going then a bit, because she's just taking about 4 inches outside the center line.
Cunningham, as Newfoundland with last rock looking for the two that will give them the opening draw win.
Pretty good shot, and then maybe just a touch too deep.
It set up the possible two for Newfoundland. Run skips rocks, BC with that 1 point advantage, but Newfoundland with the two stones counting so far.
Looks like she's trying to come through the hole as well. Tap this back a bit. Roll over into this area here. Later on in the end, of course, if it doesn't work out, she could have this one here.
The point of the end where when you're BC, you have to decide how much weight to play this with. You could try and play it very quietly, just tap it a little bit and hope to close down the house for the opponent since you do have a 1 point lead, or you could try and actually move these rocks further.
I think with that room, do you think she's trying to move it a bit, Linda, don't you?
Looks like that.
Yeah. Move it back here.
Still not.
Okay.
Is it the shot that leads to the indecision, Linda? Is it just that difficult a shot, or she realizes that
it's a difficult shot?
The game, it's the game too. I mean, it's on the line here.
Sure.
And it's a question of weight. She was trying to decide how much weight to play, whether to go for more weight and tap it or sit near it and close down the forefoot.
Off this, and how far does she bounce? Look at this.
Great
shot.
Shot.
Stone bites the edge of the button.
It's the best she could do, Linda. Couldn't do any better.
An update for you on the game between New Brunswick and Quebec, as Chantal Osborne, trailing by two with her final stone in 10, needs to sit two against Heidi Hanlon. But this stone, this sheet, just as quick as all the others, and it would be New Brunswick running Quebec out of stones to win 6-4. Heidi Hanlon
from the Thistle St. Andrews in St. John, Quebec. Chantal Osborne from Buckingham, Quebec.
So the intern looks like with that ice, she's playing it with normal weight, Linda. This turn will curl.
Can't see very much a shot rock.
Just needs to pick it out of there.
Kathy Kerr closest to the stone. Heather Martin, the front end of this Newfoundland team, got it by. Just catch a corner. They do.
It's also the best she could do in that. That's quite great rushing. You heard Laura say it does give Kelley a chance to come down and freeze to the face of it now.
Because so little of that rock was visible, she could only catch the corner, and that meant you knew she was rolling with her shot.
This is a game saving shot. If she can get the stone right in this area in front of this one, Laura Phillips will be forced to draw for the single and tie the game. But it's not a huge hole. She just threw down there. She knows the ice.
And also, Linda, we've seen that the houses are pretty active, that it really doesn't take a lot of weight. The stones will spill.
They will roll quite a way, so you do have to watch that. After such a wide open game, this end has developed very quickly into a bit of a mess for BC. Kelley has to make a huge shot here.
British Columbia and this lady, Kelley Owen, leading 3-2, but without last rock. This is the final stone for the provincial champions from the Richmond Curling Club. Now they jump it. Did they leave it too late? Oh, they did.
Well, they had to brush it
all
the way.
But how far did they push that rock?
I think Newfoundland's line two, are they not, or am I wrong? Oh, no, maybe not. You're right, Linda.
Still another rock to come, yeah. Of course, but definitely that BC stone needed to be swept all the way because of the amount it curled.
Well, yeah, it looks like the BC stone is second shot, just quickly, but. Gee, she looks like he had a great shot. It just moved, and almost like it picked something.
Well, certainly nobody was calling it.
No, well, that was the strange part about it.
All right. If the curlers had this, would they throw this stone?
Yeah, and it looks like yellow, doesn't it, or Kathy?
It does with that.
I'll tell you what. Kathy Cunningham is having a very close look. Now tell me something.
Laura was talking about playing the wide intern draw as opposed to through that little hole. She's gone back to the outturn draw down to the face of her own stone. I think she thinks that she's drawing for the win here. In other words, that the yellow is second shot.
She did her job through 8 and 9, maintaining control of last rock to get to this point. Now Laura Phillips against Kelley Owen has a chance to draw for two and the win in this opening draw of the Scott Tournament of Hearts in Vancouver.
She got it well out there.
No line from Kathy Cunningham. Kathy Kerr, a few gentle cleaning strokes, and now they'll just wait for it to bend and hopefully sit in time. Lots of weight. Now, did she bang it too far, or will it sit in time? She has her one, we know that, and now they probably measure. You bet they will. For the second point.
Just too strong. It was strong all the way. The line was fine.
One for sure in a tie game.
interesting thing, Linda, if she'd drawn with the intern and had that same weight, she would have been coming down to her own stones and she could have gone off either one of them. In towards the forefoot?
That's right, yeah.
But, I mean, you still have the outturn draw, too, so it's 6.5 does the other. But, and they have played more down that center, so you probably know your weight better.
A lot of pressure on the officials. A lot of pressure on this man. Boy.
We're watching very closely, Al.
Al Moore.
It looked to me like the red one got touched on the way by as the last shot concluded.
And right now, oh, it's one red, and it's a win for Newfoundland.
Wow, good game.
Newfoundland scores two for a 4-3 win in this opening draw. And no one more surprised than Newfoundland and Laura Phillips here in Vancouver.
This is the eighth and final game of the series. A 5-all tie. And on that wing, here's a shot. Henderson made a wild stab toward Bell. Here's another shot. Right by the door.
Relive one of hockey's greatest moments with this 1997 silver dollar from the Royal Canadian Mint. Order now. Call 1-800-267-7000. It started with a pair of boots. Kodiak boots, actually. And it just grew from there. It grew from boots to shoes. From shoes to clothing. Everything to dress you up or dress you down. Oops, not that far down. You could say that wearing Kodiaks has taken on a whole new meaning.
I like to start my morning with one special thing, a nice cup of coffee.
She's been coming in here for years, ever since I came here to work.
Good morning.
And she always orders the same thing. It's a large coffee, double cream. Well, it's quite a walk from where she lives, you know, mostly uphill.
Well, every time I go, I usually see some of my friends. It's always great to say hi. I haven't seen you for a while.
I'd say Lillian's one of the family.
In this life, some things are worth the effort.
What is Kellogg's Mueslix? Mueslix cereal has home-baked tastes like delicious apple crisp. Mueslix is an abundance of textures, ingredients like crispy flakes of whole grain, flavors of fruit, cascades of nuts and crunchy granola. We bring you Kellogg's Mueslix. Wake up to home-baked taste.
Time now for the TSN Turning Point, brought to you by Super 8 Motel. And it comes out of our featured game, Canada and Saskatchewan in the seventh end.
Well, a tremendous shot by Sandra Schmirler here. A great shot by Marilyn Bodogh had set up an opportunity to get out of this situation. A little heavy on her draw, and center makes no mistake. Bang, bang, there's the double, and there's 4 points, and that's the ball game.
As Saskatchewan goes on to a 9-2 win over the defending champions, a cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of coaches in amateur sport on behalf of TSN and Super 8 Motels, worth over 1,500 locations throughout North America. Life's great at Super 8. Hey, life's great if you're Sandra Schmirler, the curler.
You can feel the cottony softness, cottonelle.
The pain of arthritis and joint stiffness can get the better of many people. So today, there's coated extra strength aspirin with the power to relieve your worst pain right where it hurts. Aspirin, it really knows your pain.
Men, is gray hair sneaking up on you right under your nose?
It is sneaking up on me. Here, too.
You need Just for Men gel. Brush in and in 5 minutes, rinse.
It's the sure thing for a natural look.
Just for Men gel.
I've seen every card there is. Thousands of cards. Super 8's VIP card. It says, congratulations, your reservation is guaranteed, and you get 10% off. Life's great at Super 8.
I don't do my taxes. I haven't done them in 5 years. And I'm not going to do them again. I'm not losing any sleep over it. I lost more sleep when I did my taxes. Revenue Canada, they don't scare me. I got a system. It's guaranteed.
My nose is stubbed up, dry, and irritated, too.
Otrivin. New Otrivin with moisturizers.
The 1997 Scott Tournament of Hearts from Vancouver is brought to you by Scott Towels, absorbent, strong, and lots on a roll.
Coming up at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 Pacific, Ontario, the 1990 Canadian champion, Allison Goring from Bayview Country Club against from Valor Road in Winnipeg, Janet Harvey. Thanks for joining us. Canada's most comprehensive curling coverage is right here on TSN.
Ahead on TSN Sports Desk, let the games begin. We recommend you pull up a seat for the best action around. It's afternoon puck as the Flyers.